It's going to be harder probably for my mum and dad than me, given the fact they won't know who to cheer for, but it's a big weekend. It's going to be good fun playing against my brother, and it's something I've been looking forward for a long time.
Have you ever played against him before?
Only in the backyard, mate. In the backyard, they're pretty tired and tough battles, so, you know, it should be good fun. I'm sure that the spectators are going to get their money's worth, because we're going to be going ding-dong at one another, and it should be a good battle.
What a battle it will be.
And how was the father? The father, by the what name, was Gil McDougall, a great player for Western Suburbs. Man. Played for Balmain as well. He called Gil the Gay, but those were the days when those were the days when gay meant happy, frivolous, free of
innuendo.
Because that's the way he was. Yeah. He was a very, very exuberant and exhilarating player, and probably one of my favourites.
Ben and Adam clashing for the first time at North Power Stadium. The Eagles will be hoping for a big crowd to pay some wages at North Power Stadium on Sunday. The Knights normally ensure a big crowd. In round one, the Eagles upset Newcastle 12-10 at Marathon. They did exactly the same thing in round one last season. So the Northern Eagles have a pretty good record against Newcastle. I think they've won two of their three clashes.
I reckon there'll be a big crowd at this game too. Game. I mean, would you bill it as a local derby or... You know, but the people at, up at the Gosford really like Newcastle as a football team, and they're one to watch, so it should be a good crowd.
There's a mad pup, or little pup, Ben McDougall, and he's up against Mad Dog, and apparently Ben does not talk to his thighs.
You've got the other brother, Chihuahua McDougall. He's a baby brother. He goes good.
Yeah. Oh,
someone.
Yeah, I thought you were going to say they've got a sister voice.
That's that tie, I think.
I think so.
And Josh Perry's back too on the bench.
Mark, the Ewes will have to play a good game if he wants to maintain any chance of states of origin selection. Mixed opinions about his performance in Origin 1.
What about Gidley?
His defence was good. Gidley's not a 5'8". He needs a little bit more room to move to beat a man and using his rights.
He needs one-on-one, doesn't he? And to get the football early.
Imagine if A. Johns was there, the extra room with the attention Johns creates, Gidley would have, and he could really do some damage there with the numbers.
I'd almost put Badaris at halfback, put Rudder back to 5'8", because I think Badaris could cover that role and put a stopgap hooker in there maybe.
Glad you're not picking the side. Brett Camboli looking to press his origin claims and justify that $500,000 contract.
Oh, they're going on real well. I think, especially I think last week they didn't really play that well, but they still managed to win every week. So we've just got to, get our own house in order. We tend to worry too much about the opposition and then fall into making mistakes on ourselves.
Things going well for us. I mean, Michael Hagan's going very well. Everyone's in pretty good frame of mind up at home. We've won 8 games in a row. If we get this one Saturday night, we'll equal the record. So, we couldn't be happier at the moment.
Interesting game this one, Block, isn't it? And Roy, because they should fire up the Eagles. This is their local derby.
And they're saying that they've got the wood on them the last couple of games. So they got no problem about being motivated if they are going to be.
Yeah, nonetheless, I think there's too much structure with Newcastle. There seems to be a sort of a happy feeling off the field. They definitely play for each other this year.
Geez, they're not the same side without Johns, but are they? I didn't think he'd have that much impact.
No, neither. Exactly right.
You're talking about the greatest player in the rugby league world.
Mm. Exactly.
So he's obviously got to have an impact.
You got a tip?
Yeah, I'll tip Newcastle in a tight one.
Time to get our guest host out right now. Please welcome two of the greatest rugby league players in the world today, and good looking as well, Ryan Girdle and Andrew Johns. Thanks for joining us. Now, I'm looking around, boys. I'm seeing Gurge is a god, Gurge is a honey. I can't see a Johnsy sign anywhere.
Also, one of the Johnsy's got a big... Oh, they've just taken that down.
Welcome, boys. Now, injuries, we haven't seen you we won't see you for quite a while. How is that knee going?
Yeah, well, I get the brace off tomorrow. Yep. And the last week, I've really seen a lot of improvement in it. So they said earlier the Broncos game, but maybe I might be a little chance for the Parramatta Eels, which is probably about 4 weeks away. So, yeah,
and in saying that, the Knights won a couple without you, so all's not lost. They're playing pretty well.
Yeah, it's
Sean Rudder's doing a great job.
Yeah, he was in a halfback originally, and I think him and Gidsy are starting to take on that responsibility well. And you know, really, it's a kick in the guts when you know people say that they can't win just with one player. And I think the boys are sort of showing that, and they've had really good, two really good wins.
Yeah, mate. Look, I got a bit of advice for you. The extra week makes all the difference in the world. Don't come back for the Parramatta game. Just leave it for that following 7 days.
G'day, mate.
G'day, Robbo.
How are you?
Mail champ.
Yeah, I'm just going to... I'm going to empty fat sack again. First one, it's from Alicia and Bub. We're two country girls who watch the show every week and we were wondering if you could get Ryan Girdler, Andrew Johns, Craig Wing and Wendell Saylor to do the full Monty on an upcoming show.
Oh, yeah.
We would be very grateful if you make this possible as we love these guys because they all have great balls, ball skills and great bodies. Speaking of the full Monty, the
body.
Melbourne Storm boys have already beaten you to it.
Yeah, what about that?
Yeah, they all got their gear off for a...
Second one. Hi, Fatty and Mr. Sterling. My name is Matt Daly. I'm 11 year old and play for Cessnock Gowanus. I'd like to thank Andrew Johns, the greatest footballer that ever lived, for donating his $1,000 Man of the Match award to my club, the Cessnock Gowanus. Good on you, Johns.
Yeah, well done, Johns.
Another one. I recently bought my son Andrew Johns Kick Wizard. With my two hands and his two hands, that's four hands, we don't have enough fingers to put on the dots. I've written to a plastic surgeon in the US to see if he can attach some extra limbs so we can use this present. Could you ask Andrew, is this the Rubik's Cube of football?
Well, tell there us all about it, Johnsy.
Well,
Joey, what about when you recently demonstrated it? The boys had no worries.
Well, there it is, Fatty.
It's a footy, but it's,
oh,
got,
it's pretty easy, right?
It's everywhere. It's like a twister on
yeah,
a football.
Yeah, but he is from Cessnock. They got three ends.
You can't say that about Cessnock.
Can we have a look at how you explained it to the young kids up in Newcastle?
Yeah, we had a day out there and it was pretty easy actually. I showed the kids how to kick the ball.
Let's have a
You'll
look.
See it.
So put your hands on there first. That's left, buddy. Turn
I got
around.
The bomb one.
Yeah, that's nice. Yeah, right one there, mate. Put your right hand there. That's left, buddy.
No, yeah, this hand.
Right.
Yeah, that's it.
Andrew, kick it to me!
Yes!
Not like that. No, wrong way.
Wrong way, buddy. Right thumb. That's boy. Like that. Unbelievably. Have a look at that. Bit different to the torpedo kick, because when you strike a torpedo downfield, the ball's flat. When we hit the torpedo bomb, are you in there listening? See, this ball does work. What a great Easter present it would be. I would love one of those when I was a kid. And the $24.95.
I think they filmed that the day after the last footy show and didn't show up.
That's
so
why you didn't show up.
I got an excuse.
But tell us about the kicking tee.
Oh, yeah, this is the kicking tee. Me and Daryl, actually. Daryl Halligan.
Daryl Halligan?
Yeah, done some lessons with him, and we came up with this kicking tee. And actually, if you watch on the weekend, Billy Pooten won from the sideline with this tee. So it's a good product, and it sells for $19.95. And you can buy them at Big W, Rebel, Kmart, Sports Scene, or any Versace.
And of course, the Peter Sterling Pro-Yo as well.
You can get it for 10 cents at any Salvo store.
You can do the drop kick, the reverse pass, and feed the scrum with the Peter Sterling Pro-Yo.
All right, that's all we've got time for. Thanks, Robbo, with the emails.
Thanks, Pat.
Thanks, champ. And we'll take a break and come back and wrap it off here on The Footy Show. That's all we've got time for tonight. Please, a big thank you to Ryan Girdler, Andrew Johns.
Well done, boys. Thanks for coming on the show. Sneaky Pete. And we'll see you next week on The Footy Show. Bye for now.
Now time to look at the Newcastle Knights. And a short time ago, I caught up with their coach, Michael Hagan.
Yeah, we've put ourselves in a good place after the first round, but it all starts again starting tonight, doesn't it, with the Northern Eagles. But it's a terrific point to get this far, but we've got a bit of work to do between now and the end of the year.
looking for a record equaling ninth win in a row. Does that put any pressure on the side in itself?
I'm not sure that it does. I mean, we've strung a few games together. We probably won a couple of games that we probably may not have won in some circumstances. So we've had an ounce of luck in a few, but we're certainly looking to build on what we've worked on the last few weeks. So another one along the way would be a nice bonus for us.
2 weeks without Andrew Johns. Are the players getting used to not having him around now?
Well, he's still around. He's just not on the field with them. But I think there's other players taking the responsibility from him, and I think they're doing a pretty good job, to be fair to them.
No need to remind you that the Eagles beat you in your debut back at Marathon. They've been under pressure as well this week. How do you think that will affect them?
Well, I think it'll probably help them in terms of their motivation to play us, because there's a fair Newcastle contingent in their football team, and Sharpie, who comes from Newcastle originally, so I'm sure they've got plenty of reasons to play well against us, and they did that in the first round.
They do have a very strong forward pack as well. Obviously, most games are won there.
Yeah, I think that's a fair point. I think Mealy and Adam Muir in particular going very well, played very strongly against Brisbane last week, and I think Brecken Morley might find some of his best form for us tonight.
Good luck.
Thank you.
There is Michael Hagan, the coach of the Newcastle Knights, having an outstanding start to his coaching career.
To rugby league, and Newcastle was chasing its ninth straight win when they took on the cash-strapped Northern Eagles tonight. But they soon learned that a club in crisis can be a dangerous opponent.
For the club. The Northern Eagles promised fireworks at home, but the early minutes were a fizzer, a barrage of penalties dominating the game and the scoring. When the tries finally got underway, it was the home side striking first.
Larry King try! They finally turned possession into points.
But then the Knights hit the lead thanks to a quality ball from Mark Hughes.
Great ball to Tamana Tahu, and he has scored the try.
Adam Muir gave a tough ball for referee Stephen Clark. Not much thanks for awarding the Eagles with a penalty in front to lock the scores up at 8-all. The Eagles resorting to the kick again for their second try.
Here's a chance. Walker, can he get there? No. Danny Lima has.
Despite leading, the home side was still looking clumsy. And when Wayne Evans handed the ball straight to Newcastle just before half-time, the Knights were within two.
Inside Kamali, and they pay dearly. Darren Albert has scored in the corner.
It was another penalty that gave the Eagles a four-point lead right on the break. Stephen Clark spoke to both captains after half-time about the penalties, then denied the visitors a try with a questionable forward pass ruling. But the Knights couldn't be denied when Kennedy ran onto the perfect ball.
Ball to Gidley, last tackle. They must score here. Kennedy goes himself, gets the ball over.
McDougall put the Knights further ahead when he pounced on a well-placed kick.
Here's the kick. McDougall gets the try.
Once again, the scores were locked with Greg Ebrill crossing for his first top-grade try.
On the inside to Ebrill. He turned 22 yesterday. Today he scored a try.
Eagle fans rose again when Adam Muir showed his full range of skills.
He gets the ball away. How do he do that to Ben Walker?
Then a blow for New South Wales. Winger Adam McDougall stretched from the field with what looked like a serious ankle injury. Then, with only minutes to go, the Knights crossed again. Billy Peden had been kicking well all night and needed this kick to end the game in a draw.
Quite an upset there. The final score, 30-28. More than 18,000 fans bringing some much-needed revenue through the gates for the Eagles. As for the Knights, Billy Peden shattered at missing that final kick for goal.
I'm very devastated, actually. You know, I thought it would have been great to try and salvage a draw for the boys, but it wasn't to be. So, yeah, full credit to the Eagles. You know, they played very well and made us pay for our mistakes, but you know, it's something we'll have to work on is our ball control next week, because you just can't afford to turn that much ball over in a game and attempt to win it.
After a week of innuendo about how much cash they have in the bank, the Northern Eagles got back to playing rugby league last night. The visitors to Gosford were neighbours, the Newcastle Knights, who were looking for their ninth win in a row.
A battle quickly becoming a local derby, doubled as a match for the Eagles to put aside off-field dramas. That urgency converted to points early.
They've finally turned possession into points.
Newcastle's revenge came from Tamana Tahu, but fell further behind when an awkward bounce fell in Eagles' arms. Darren Albert narrowed the gap to 14-12 at half-time. After the break, a classic Gidley setup had the Knights celebrating. Ben Walker completed Muir's hard work to put the Eagles back in front. The Knights, anxious to salvage a draw, scored 6 minutes from full-time. Somehow, Billy Peden's kick to level the scores didn't go over. Newcastle's injury toll continues. Adam McDougall twisting his ankle.
Well, actually, you saw an outstanding performance last night in Newcastle, where a rugby player sadly missed the opportunity of getting his team a draw. But a feat of kicking that was displayed last night in that particular game, that conversion attempt, is something that even the most brilliant of AFL could never possibly emulate. Let's follow the path of this ball now and look at the majestic skills of rugby league, where we can actually play snooker. Boom. Boom, boom.
Yeah. You got nothing for that.
Yes. No, you got nothing.
No, you got nothing for that. And it, well, therefore, it wasn't a draw. They lost the game.
Let's have a look at the overnight package. A couple of games last night, they were beauties.
Getting out on the field.
Over 18,000 made their way to North Power Stadium for the local derby between Newcastle and the Northern Eagles. And it was the home side that drew first blood. When Mark Hughes got a great ball to Tahu, the Knights were over as well.
Scored the try.
Ben Kennedy was Johnny on the spot to show his fleet of foot.
It's gone to Kennedy.
But the next four-pointer went to the Eagles. Danny Lima's first ever in the NRL. Up 14-8 just before the break, the Eagles were thinking about a half-time rest when Albert pounced. Down 16-12 early in the second stanza, the Knights hit the front through Kennedy. When Gidley showed some great vision, Newcastle were up by six.
McDougall gets the try.
After a week of high drama for the Eagles off the field, it was time for them to stand up.
Now McDougall, ball there to Robert Miles, back on the inside to Everall.
When Muir got another miracle ball away, the home side led 30-24.
This is unbelievable by Adam Muir.
Awful news for the Knights and New South Wales when Adam McDougall went off with a serious ankle injury.
Just watch that ankle, get caught underneath.
But the Knights weren't done with. A combination of luck and brilliance, and they trailed by two. Bill Peden needing this to tie things up.
He's going to hit the upright and the crossbar.
At the end of a week where their future looked so terribly bleak, the Eagles soared to beat the competition frontrunners 30-28.
And Adam McDougall, the news from the Newcastle coach Michael Hagan this morning. Again, they're confident there's no break, but definitely ligament damage. But they will learn more this afternoon when Dr. Neil Halpin makes his way to Newcastle for the full examination of Adam.
More bad news for New South Wales in the lead-up to State of Origin 2. Winger Adam McDougall was stretched from the field with an ankle injury in last night's loss to the Northern Eagles. It was 30-28. The cash-strapped Eagles ending the night's eight-match winning streak.
In typical Adam McDougall fashion, he gave his all in the local derby. Just minutes from the end, that Newcastle pride turned to pain. An ankle injury which could rule him out of Origin 2.
Just watch that ankle get caught underneath in Ben Walker's tackle.
McDougall is hoping it's just ligament damage and not a break.
Not sure. I have to get some scans on that.
Those x-rays will be taken tomorrow to determine the full extent of the injury. Newcastle's night didn't get any better. With 3 minutes remaining, night skipper Bill Peden had a chance to level the scores by converting Bill Kennedy's second try.
He's going to hit the upright and the crossbar. I don't believe what I've seen.
And neither did the Northern Eagles, a much-needed win for the financially embattled club.
The people in charge of the club are more than capable. We've run the club and that's in their hands, and our job is to play football. And the more we play like we did tonight, the better the crowds are going to be, the better the sponsorship's going to be.
Last week, Brett Camorley was branded one of the causes of the club's financial trouble, but the coach is adamant the big spend to lure him to the Eagles was justified.
He's been placed under undue pressure by the print media in Sydney. For whatever reasons, I would not have a clue, you know. He's certainly not the problem at this club, that's for sure. He's the answer at this club.
So euphoric was last night's win, security will now be closely monitored to prevent another ground invasion.
The ankle injury to Newcastle's Adam McDougall isn't as bad as first thought. Clinton Fletcher, National 9 News.
Knights winger Adam McDougall is confident he can overcome an ankle injury. Patrick Mullahan, 7 News.
Newcastle winger Darren Albert is in huge demand from English clubs. The speedy flanker would like to stay with the NRL and the Knights, but Albert is incensed by suggestions he's demanding too much money. Ironically, he's on the verge of becoming the club's most prolific try scorer.
Darren Albert is scanning the horizon in more ways than one.
The Knights pin-up boy has hit stormy waters in his negotiations with the Newcastle management, and he could soon be forced to spread his wings.
Got some good options in the NRL, plus in England, and also, you know, got a good option out of the rugby union too.
Albert, the hero of the club's 1997 grand final victory over Manly, has been poorly portrayed in the media, with claims he's demanding $240,000 from the cash-strapped Knights.
I fully expected, with the salary cap issues and things like that, to take a cut this year. And so when it came to negotiations, you know, to get even close to what I was getting this year, I would have been happy.
Albert's new manager is launching a witch hunt to find out how details of his client's contract were leaked to the press.
But I'll be actually this week looking into how the media got hold of all these figures of his current contract and also, you know, his offer, because I think that's quite unethical. That's private business between Darren, his manager, and the club.
In the meantime, Albert is defending his injury record after having two seasons foiled by a chronic foot problem.
My foot's going great this year. I'm running as fast as I have been ever.
Daniel Lane, 10 News.
Next up on Winners, we check out the Newcastle Knights and that injury to Adam McDougall.
I walked in here yesterday before I got the x-rays and basically thought my season was over, and particularly when I heard the crack on the field on the weekend, you know, I just first thought that came to my head was that's the year.
Adam McDougall has to, he's been unable to train all week with that injured ankle, and he's keen to play though.
I'm pleasantly surprised to find out this morning that, you know, I could be back as soon as maybe 1 or 2 weeks, so I'm over the moon and have to thank my lucky stars that I've got out of this one unscathed at the moment. Given the fact that it is a Friday night game, it's going to be pretty tough to back up for it, but we've got a few injuries at the moment in the camp, so you know, the club's got to come first, and if I'm called upon to roll up my sleeves and contribute, well, I'm willing to pave a little bit of pain and just see how things go.
What about that? Oh, he hasn't been under an injury cloud. He's been under an injury thunderstorm.
Jesus Christ,
he's
unbelievable. Play with a bit of pain.
Maybe monsoon.
I'll make a bet that he doesn't play tomorrow night against the Roosters. He'll get chosen for New South Wales. He'll miss a couple of games. He'll be back for the one against Brisbane, which is with Wendell Saylor, and then the third State of Origin.
Yeah, McDougall undergoing a fitness test as we speak at the training session tonight at Marathon Stadium. Marathon is the venue for the Newcastle Roosters match. This will be a cracker. The Roosters have slipped down to fifth position on the competition ladder. You were speaking with Graham Murray, or he was at the press conference. Alarm bells, are they starting to ring for the Roosters?
No, I think they'll win tomorrow night. And I think that...
You think the Roosters will win?
Yep.
Yeah, I do too, Roy. I'm with you.
Even though they've got a great record up there, and I think that they'll be set to demonstrate that the domination they showed over them in that semi-final last year was no fluke.
They've got the ability to lift when they really need to. And we all mentioned earlier in the show, Newcastle Knights without Johnsy have been pretty substandard, really. I mean, the Roosters have got the ability and the ammunition to beat them.
And, of course... changing positions there with Mark Hughes going back to the centres. Robbie O'Davis now starting in the fullback position. Gidley, I thought, I'm the only bloke on the panel who thinks he's a 5'8". Thought he had a big game last weekend in the number 6 jumper.
He just reminds me so much of G Miles as a player. I think he's wasted at 5'8". I think out wide he just does his own thing and he doesn't have to make as much tackles as well. And just look on this game, number 14 there, Corkadidas, is it? Corkadidas?
Yeah, good player.
Very good player. Yeah. Very, very willing. Just keep an eye on him the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, it's been a tough year for Morley, hasn't it? I mean, we've mentioned him a lot of times on the show so far.
He hasn't adapted.
I thought he played all right last week, actually, but if you're going to give a bloke a go, you've got to put him on for 4 or 5 weeks. Yeah. Put him in the starting side. On. Don't keep putting him on the bench and putting him in the side and putting him on the bench and putting him in the side.
Have they got the front row to win a premiership, Roy?
Well, the game's changed. I mean, yeah. I'd have to say that the front row is still the most important position in rugby league. The halfback second, back row is third, then the centre's fourth, and then after that, I don't care.
the rest of them go and get the beers.
That's right. But you've got to say that that's probably one area where with the game has changed a little bit, and you possibly can get by without having two dominant front rowers.
Let's go to the coach then. Coach Graham Murray looking for back-to-back success and gives Michael Hagan a big rap.
There's no doubt he was all making a fist of it. He's a good coach, he's a good bloke, and he handles it very well. I mean, there's no doubt he was going to make a real good go of his first year. I was always keen to win at Newcastle. I mean, I had a terrific time there, but it'll be a tough game for us, and it's never any different there at Marathon Stadium. Look, they're passionate about their football team, and they were anti-me when I was with Illawarra, and they were anti-me when I was with the Mariners. Nothing changes, and they'll still be the same when I'm now with the Roosters. So it's healthy. I think it's terrific. It'll be a big crowd, which they love their team up there.
We often forget, don't we, about the Hunter Mariners? And, of course, that year they played in the Super League competition in 1997. Michael Hagan, the assistant there to Graham Murray.
Survival of the fittest, mentally and physically, you think on the pick of them?
No.
Yes, you do.
No.
You just said.
No, Paul Harrigan.
You just said.
Paul Harrigan.
Paul Harrigan, your kidney wouldn't. What could he do for you?
Lots.
What's doing with you?
Not much, bro.
What are you doing in here?
I can just split up with your missus, eh?
You split up with your missus?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Do you want to say anything to her on telly, try to win her back or anything?
I'd just like to say, you know, come back soon, please. I miss you. Yeah. Yeah.
Two things come to mind when I look at you.
What's that?
The footy show and Survivor. I'll tell you straight, boys, I'll be the sole survivor. I'm going to be the one right to the very end. I'll tip you something, Fat. I won't be first to go. Good luck, boys. But remember, you're up against Robbo.
And we haven't heard from the chief. Chief, how you feeling, chief?
Just proud to be here, mate. Proud to be here. All the boys. Plenty of funny stories before we come out. It's been great. Very excited.
We've had a great hour at the back, haven't we? Wouldn't be a bad forward pack, actually, if we took some forwards out of this. I think I'd be on the bench, that's for sure. But
good.
Now, listen, Robbo, anything?
I'm very confident. A lot of little people out there will vote for me. And the racing fraternity will get behind me.
How would the racing fraternity get behind you? They've forgotten about you, haven't they?
I don't think so.
Are you trying to look higher with that
hair? You might be forgotten.
What's going on?
I just reckon I'm a little chief. So I look like poor, I reckon.
That's a fuck off. Hey?
I'd rather look like chief than Lang, mate. That's what about that? Hey, his kidney couldn't get his shirt done up. Broman had to jump on the last roll.
Preview of tomorrow night's game. Of course, the game that we're covering is up at Marathon Stadium, where Newcastle Knights are at home to the Roosters. It should be an outstanding game. Two of the former sides of the comp. And let's have a look at the ins and outs. Jobson in for McDougal. And for the Knights, for the Roosters, no changes at all. And let's have a look at the team cards now. Newcastle, well, apart from Andrew Johns, Pete, just about at their strongest.
Well, yeah, apart from McDougal as well, and yeah. Justin Ryder comes in on the wing there, and look, it's a very solid-looking side. I look, Matt Gidley, Gus, starting to look very, very much at home in the 5-8 spot, and, you know, the forward pack is getting the job done, but the halves, I think, are going pretty well.
Gidley was outstanding up there at North Power Stadium the other night. He's really starting to feel comfortable closer to the play and getting into a little bit of fitness. You've got to remember, he missed most of the start of the season, and he came back straight into Origin football. He's had a pretty torrid time, but he's going to be much better for the football he's played when we get around to Origin too.
Chief, what does Robbie O'Davis in the starting lineup mean to this side?
I think it's a big... he's not going to last too much longer. He has got a broken thumb. It will need a pin in it. Actually, a few of our players, Rudder needs an arthroscope on his shoulder. And Tamana Tahu, he's been playing the last 2 or 3 weeks with Compartrum syndrome, which is a calf condition. So he's been playing really well, but we're carrying a few injuries, so they'll have to do it sooner than later. But Robbie O'Davis, big plus for us, and just the fact that he's going to be there is going to help us. But I think that the Roosters, the difference between, you can see the side there, with Newcastle and the Roosters, a couple of games. The last game we won, obviously, at the start of the season, and Andrew Johns was instrumental in that. And the good news about Andrew, he'll be back in 3 to 4 weeks, which is good, he's on track. But every time, Gus, that we get a good lead in the past, they've always wheeled us back. And I think that's changed this year. We've changed our game the Knights a little bit and a bit more sound. Keep that intensity a little bit more.
Unusual for you, Gus, to tip the Roosters again.
Yeah,
they really haven't been playing that well, though, have they? Shaky win last week against the Tigers.
No, the last month has been very poor. I mean, there's a couple of things coming out in their game, and they've had a few different reshuffles to their side. I like the fact that Luke Phillips is now back at fullback. He's had one full game in first grade. He'll be a lot better for the run. He gives them a lot of composure from the back. I just get the feeling, since Andrew Johns has been out, they sort of struggled to beat the Cowboys in a high-scoring game. They struggled to beat the Panthers up at Penrith Park. The other night against the Northern Eagles, they had a chance to win but let it slip again. And I just might be looking at one team perhaps heading into a little bit of a mid-season trough, and hopefully the Roosters coming out of it. And a fair bit of talk about the Roosters this week that they'll improve dramatically on what they've been showing.
Darryl, you're the other person to pick a Roosters victory. Probably no tougher road trip than Marathon.
No, I don't think so. Look,
I think it's a must-win game for them. They're on 17 points, Newcastle 21. If Newcastle beat them, they've kicked well clear of them.
They'll go to 23.
Yeah, 23, and thanks a lot. But they will be a long way behind. I just think the Roosters will win. You keep waiting for them to turn their season around or their form around, but they really haven't done it. I think they'll do it tomorrow night. Right, I really think they can win.
Thanks, Darryl. One of the form players for Newcastle has been their winger, Justin Ryder, and he caught up with all the players, spoke to them about this big match tomorrow night.
Hi, how are you going, guys? It's the Knight Rider here. Just turned up to Marathon Stadium to start training. Got to find out why I'm not on the side this week. I'm going to go find my regular driver, Robbie O. So let's go find him. Robbie, where are you?
Yeah, know how to handle it, or you needed me to drive it around?
Mate, you fight the crime for me. I just do the good looking, brother. Let's go see some of the boys, eh, Kit?
I think so, mate. What do you reckon?
Let's start her up, boys.
Still bubbles.
What do you reckon? Do I look like David Hasselhoff?
Hasselhoff, I'd say you look more like Kenny off South Park.
Fair game, mate. I've got the looks.
What are you talking?
Here I am with Coach Michael Hagan. 8 wins in a row. How does it feel?
What about last week, mate? Don't you count that one?
No, I don't want to remember that.
I think it's we're on a roll at the moment, mate. None from the last one.
Rumour has it that Nugget's back this week and I might be on the bench or in first division. Is there any chance I can run somewhere else?
Mate, you never know your luck, mate. If you've got an ounce of luck, you'll be playing Friday.
Mate, I've got big legs. I've got to play in the front row.
Mate, you got a big heart too.
I've got a big head, Paul. Well, let's pack it here, Robbie O. Mate, there's trouble in the sheds. Let's go.
Okay, Dave.
But here I am with the Newcastle skipper and hero, Andrew Johns. Mate, how's it been, the injury?
I can't understand you, mate.
But no one can. Here we are with Newcastle skipper, Andrew Johns.
Speaking to his nose.
How has it been, Andrew?
You got a broken nose.
Mate, I'll break yours in a second. How have you been and how's the injury been?
Oh, about 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Yeah. Actually, you in first grade this week might be coming through reserve grade this week. Oh, Doogie's out, sir. You'll be right, big boy.
Thanks, buddy. How can we turn around this week and beat the Roosters?
Oh, mate, I think we just not drop the ball as much, mate, and get it to our little red-headed winger, mate, I think. He's going all right, so if we get the ball to him a bit more, we'll probably win the game.
Mate, rumour has the game plan this week is give me the ball and I'll score, isn't it?
I think so, mate. I think it's a pretty good plan.
Mate, Gillian, Newcastle 5'8". Mate, what's your prev... Mate, you looking forward to the New South Wales game next weekend?
Oh, don't kick that bike.
It's going well, mate. It's going well.
Are you looking forward to next State of Origin and how can you beat the Queenslanders?
Yeah, mate, if we get picked on Sunday again, we've got to try and turn things around. That beat us pretty well in the first game, but I think we just keep a bit hungry for the next game. We should go okay.
Thanks, mate. How are we going to beat the Roosters?
What was that, mate?
Rumour has it, I've got feedback from all the boys that I need an interpreter. Would you stick your hand up and help me out?
No, mate, you're pretty good.
Mate, I'm number 18 this week, and I can't help but feel that it's your fault that I'm number 18.
Mate, as soon as I first laid eyes on you, you were destined to wear two numbers. I thought one or two or five was a bit short for you, so I think you're getting close to the mark.
It's about time you give me some quality ball, though.
Mate, it's about time you have some quality interviewing.
We've heard from all the boys. It's time for me to go out and do a bit extra now in case Mad Dog doesn't play. We'd like to see you all there on Friday night for us against the Roosters. See you later from the Knight Rider.
Oh, the Knight Rider.
Good on you, Justin. Job well done there, despite the boys giving you a bit of curry. It was good work.
No, one for the Chief.
Oh!
When will poor old Paul Harrigan learn to do up his own tie? I was in the next box to the guys at the first Origin match a couple of weeks ago with one of the highlights being Gus Gould leaning over... Chief to do his tie-up for him. And the 100 or so punters cheering him on as they did so.
Well read, mate.
One to you, Chief.
Thanks very much, mate. Bit of applause, mate.
That's a long one. Here's one from the Higgins clan. Dear Fatty and Sterlo, thank you for sending Nathan an answer to his email. In the past, Nathan has had a lot of problems and was always getting into trouble at school. That was until he went to a Newcastle Knights footy game and he got to meet Paul Harrigan. Nathan is ADHD and his future looked pretty glum. But thanks to people like Paul and the both of you who take the time out to talk to Nathan and, of course, football, things have turned around for Nathan. So from a grateful mum, I thank you. Yeah. Sure. Go the night.
Well, last chance to impress the selectors before the State of Origin teams are named on Sunday. A game with plenty of candidates is, of course, the Knights and the Roosters tonight in Newcastle. Tony Peters joins us. Any late changes to either side?
Yes, Tim, the Newcastle Knights have lost winger Adam McDougall with an ankle injury. He's replaced by Justin Ryder. The Roosters are as per big league program. Referee is Bill Harrigan. Full-time in jersey flag. The Roosters 22 defeated the Knights 16.
Yeah, it's all set up, isn't it? The Roosters and the Knights will lift, and really, both of them need to improve, particularly the Roosters.
Yes, as you well know, Tim, the Roosters have won just one game in the last four that they've played, and that was last weekend against the West Tigers. Previous to that, they lost to Parramatta, they drew with the Dragons, and were embarrassed against the New Zealand Warriors. But the mood was good at training this week, Tim. It's a big occasion, and coach Graham Murray expects his side to lift for the Knights.
Yeah, they're always tough up there. They're on, I would imagine, a big crowd, and last year we were well and truly beaten up there. And they beat us in the first round. So, you know, they're a good football team. And I think last week we showed a couple of good signs, not a whole 80 minutes, but a couple of good signs to say that we're back on track slightly.
Yeah, but the Knights are very hard to beat at Marathon.
Yeah, they certainly are. But the Roosters don't have a bad record up there, Tim. Overall, if you look at the history of the two sides that have played there, it's a two-game difference at the moment in favour of the Newcastle Knights. But first round this year was a significant one for the Knights. They won 25-18 here at the Sydney Football Stadium. When you look at the Roosters' record at Marathon overall, it isn't very good, but two of their three wins have been in recent seasons against the Knights. Last year, that was a bad result. They copped the belting 46-12.
Week long treatment on his injured ankle, Newcastle's Adam McDougall will join Andrew Johns on the sideline, but fullback Robbie O'Davis will play despite a broken thumb.
From the beautiful Marathon Stadium in the glorious heart of the Hunter, it's the Knights at Night. After spending most of the season at the top of the ladder, the Red and Blues are at home to the Sydney Roosters, and the Newcastle Stars will be out in force. Stars like Mark Hughes.
He gets the ball back to Beaton. Beaton gives it away for the centre. He's over the line. Mark Hughes.
Darren Albert.
Davis kicks for Albert.
Matthew Gidley.
Gidley a step. He'll go for the line. Passes back inside for Bailey.
Ben Kennedy.
The pass for the halfback. Kennedy goes straight through.
Danny Badaris.
Here they go through the centre. Kennedy's there. Danny Badaris. That's a tie to Newcastle.
Robbie O'Davis.
Through, but this man, Robbie O'Davis. Sparkling form.
And to Marner Tahu.
And there's Tahu. Tahu's into the gap. He's looking for number two. He's going to make it as he is. Tahu's over.
Those Roosters will be seeing stars if these stars cut loose. And you'll see it all in living color. Tonight on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
I know everything about the game of rugby league, and you know, I'd never turn me back on the game at this stage of my career, and I'm just happy for doing what I'm doing at the moment. It's a terrific game, and you know, good luck to the guys. Everyone makes their own decisions in life, but I wouldn't walk away from this. You know, just come here today and see what we've got here. Very lucky.
Adam McDougall there, who was pretty harsh against Matt Rogers, saying he'd never leave league. Sources pretty close to management of McDougall say he virtually had signed on the dotted line with the ARU last year before Newcastle came back with a better offer. He was on his way to the ARU, and of course, as we pointed out, Gridiron, of course, he wanted to go and play Gridiron. And now he's saying, how dare you turn your back on rugby league?
It's a bit of hypocrisy there.
It's everyone's personal.
It's money. It's all money, isn't it?
Yeah, good luck.
It's all money.
If you want to go and do that, go and do it.
Now look, it's time now. I'm going to stand up to do this. I'm going to stand up. This is one of the biggest announcements the footy show's ever seen, right? To announce the permanent third host. I'm going to do this. Have a look in here. Oh, you beauty. It's not Mario Fennec. Yeah! We love you, Moses. It is, in fact, one of the greatest players we've ever seen. He was the last captain of the country team. Please make him welcome Paul the Chief Harrigan. We'll be right back. Now tell us, it was a very close vote at Wayne Pearce's right up there, but you only found out at lunchtime today when you got the call.
Yeah, it's been a big week. Got the call at lunchtime today, busy working on the mobile, and yeah, rang Mum and Dad and busily got up here, got on the aeroplane. It's been great. Very
exciting.
What
do you think this will do for you and your...
Oh, I don't know.
Credibility-wise.
Getting to hang out with you guys most of the week, that'll be fantastic. Well,
that's the big thing, Chief. You now realise that you work 6.5 days
a week.
18 hours a day.
Yeah.
You'll handle
meetings.
That?
Yeah, I can do that. But no, it's been a great week, really exciting, and... can't wait to keep
Andy Ads, you'll be in all the Andy Ads, the Chief, and all the Andy Ads as well.
They're all the time. No,
excellent
great.
Work. Well, congratulations, Chief.
Thanks
for joining us. We are deeply honoured to have you as a third member of the panel, Chief.
Well, thanks, mate. You've done. Yeah, give it to him. Of course, the great thing is, of course, Chief, is you've been a part of the show for a long, long time now and
it's
done some
now,
wonderful,
yeah.
wonderful things, hasn't it?
Chief's been on this show off and on for quite a long time. Let's have a look at some of Chief's highlights.
What about Marcel Harrigan? He just did nothing. It's like on the football field. If anything, he's the biggest cat I've ever seen play football.
What's going on, pal?
Just saying what a great player you were.
I'll tell you what, next week, they're going to give you the flick. They're going to sit Ron a McDonald in that chair, feed him up full of McDonald's so he's close, 10, 12K, and he'll look exactly like you. And Tool's a better joke.
Oh, good chat. Go sit down, will you?
What State of Origin means to me is probably the chance to mix with some of the best blokes on and off the field. I'll start again in. If you play well, you get the chance to play for Australia. That's what it's all about. Let's see what some of the... The main thing for me is the chance to play for Australia. Let's sink. All right, won't be long now. We'll get there. Come on, be my friend. Microphone. The chance to play for Australia. Let's see what some of the... I can't say that.
Because you're playing your brother this weekend, always a tough game. You regard him as your toughest opponent. But he's just been cut from the Queensland side, so he's going to be extra determined to make sure he plays well.
He's been cut, has he?
Yeah.
Who's looking now?
I'm not quite sure. You see a lot of rugby league players going over to Union. Well, actually, you don't see many. Willie Khan's been the only one, but you see the others.
Oh, beautiful.
Wow.
I've got what it takes.
No, we love your work and you will fit in beautifully on this show. Paul Harrigan, well done.
Now, how different did you look at that first?
Oh, no, you actually had hair in those days.
A lot of hair.
That was disgraceful.
Welcome back to the Footy Show live here from Bathurst. I've got the Rugby League Road Train here behind me, thanks to Telstra. Let's go and have a look. Come on, let's check it out. There's the boys up there. Now, this thing is dead set massive. As I said, it's a road train and it's got heaps of good stuff. We've got grand final jumpers, footballs, the ultimate trophies from years gone by, and it's going to 40 regional cities around New South Wales, as I said before, Melbourne and Brisbane. You can see the World Cup just there. What a wonderful trophy that is. Now, mums and dads, make sure you get your kids, when it comes to your town, to come down and check this out. With the JJ Gilton Shield, State of Origin Shield, plus much, much more. Heaps of computers. Now, you can see right here, we've got a phone, a message. You can ring up your favourite player and get an exclusive message to him. But all in all, it's a wonderful idea. Now, the road train is on the website at www.nrl.com. So get on there and log on the net. And I've got to say, just before we go back to you, Fat Man, this is a wonderful concept. Congratulations to the NRL. And mums and dads, get your kids down and check this out. It's great. Back to you, Fat Man.
Thanks, Chief. Go on, Chief. Thanks very much, mate. He'll be back in a minute.
However, Newcastle winger Darren Albert is considering a switch of codes.
Yeah, I'm extremely serious. You know, we had a meeting with them on the weekend, last weekend, and got some good information out of that.
Andrew McKinlay, National 9 News.
Anyway, for the second Origin in succession, Adam McDougall lifted his knee in an Origin game. This time he was suspended for 1 week.
Yeah, it was unfortunate, a bit lazy and... As a result, I'm going to miss a game of football now, but as I said, there was no intent, and sorry that it happened, and it ruined a pretty good night. You know, it's going to be pretty hard to outweigh the joy of tonight. You know, the guys really stood up and they were counted for, and it was a terrific team performance, and you know, as long as I'm available for the next game, that's the main thing, and I'll be ready and raring to go. Mate, you know, I enjoy playing Wendell, and he enjoys playing me, and everyone has their good nights and bad nights, and you know, I was just glad that he had a bad night.
There you have it, the game hit him with a feather duster. Marathon will be rocking on Sunday, no doubt about that. The Bulldogs still seething after their 32-0 loss to Canberra. How bad are you going when you lose 32-0 to Canberra? Newcastle without Andrew Johns, still short-priced favourites for this game. The referee is Tim Manor. Don't forget, in round three, it was Newcastle reigning supreme. Still a good-looking side, but there's still no A. Johns, and he'd make a big difference to any side.
Yeah, I think we're about to see the turnaround of the year in this game. I think the Bulldogs will knock them off up there.
You really believe that?
I really do. I really do.
I asked you when I seen my tipping competition for the Sydney Morning Herald earlier who was going to win that, and you told me Newcastle.
Yeah, I do one for the Penrith Press, so I've got to make sure that we...
he's got five going. He names different ones all the time.
No, I just do. I don't think... I heard you in there, Roy. Sorry, mate, but I would have told you that I think that Anasta's back this week. And I think he's going to have a bit of... Yeah, we go there in Trindle,
They got flogged 2 weeks ago. Yeah. How can they turn it around that much?
I just think this... As I just said, it's probably an outlandish statement, like most of mine are in this show, but... I think he's this team will beat the Knights up there this weekend.
Got a little bit more speed around the halves, haven't they? Gidley, I still don't think has come to grips at 5'8". I'd like to see him out a little bit wider one-on-one, but him and Rudder, not that much pace there.
Last week on Footy Show Survivor, the fat man gave everyone a scare.
Oh, you beauty, it's not Mario Benning. Yeah!
But in the end, it came down to one.
For the Chief Harrigan!
And it was time to hail the Chief. And didn't we set Bathurst on fire?
Well, Harrigan drifted into the dressing room after the game, caught up with all the winning players.
Well, it's only your second State of Origin. What was it like running out here, seeing that big grandstand over the other side? Very exciting.
Yeah, special night tonight, Chief. You know, we had a lot of pressure on us through the week and the boys responded. The crowd here was sensational tonight and we've played well and it's just a magical night.
Giz, can you improve another notch for the next game?
I think we can, Chief. Things like the last 20 minutes when we sort of turned a little bit of ball over, when we probably should have, you know, worked out a few more sets. But, I mean, there's definitely things we can still work on for the third game. But, I mean, that's a big improvement from the first one.
How sweet's the beer, big fella?
Yeah, it's really good. I'll have a few more tonight.
Okay, maybe he rubbed the Denker rub on his melon before he went out tonight?
He did, mate. And I even offered to give him some extra hot Denker rub, but he wasn't too game to do it. But, mate, I've never seen anyone do that before. And I tell you what, he hasn't got the full set of marbles upstairs to do that.
Is he madder than you, Mad Dog?
Oh, mate. He's 20 times madder than me. He'd put DP on their face. Fair dinkum.
Guns in our game today, Matthew Gidley. He'll be in action up there at Marathon Stadium for Newcastle. They take on the Bulldogs, and let's have a look and see where these teams are on the ladder. I think you'll find that Newcastle are third and the Bulldogs on fifth, and it should be an absolute ball tear up there. The Knights take on the Bulldogs, and Peter Stirling joins us. G'day, Sneak. Thanks for coming in there from Marathon Stadium. G'day, mate.
There you go. And we've nearly got Falcon here. We're nearly claiming compo, but a nice sunny day here at Marathon. A little bit windy, but it should ensure a good crowd for this clash between the Knights and the Bulldogs. A couple of players out from both sides, and one of those men join us now, one of our State of Origin stars, Adam McDougall. Firstly, Adam, congratulations on Sunday night, but a little bit of bitter out of the sweet was the fact you're on the sidelines for a week after the lifting of the knee. What was your reaction to that?
Obviously, as soon as it happened, I was very disappointed. It took a lot of shine off a great night, and as a result, I'm paying the penalty now. So the Knights really needed me tonight. It's a do-or-die game for us, and we're coming off the back of two defeats, so it's going to be a great game here today, and I'm just really disappointed I'm not involved.
There's a bit of publicity, obviously, an incident last year's series with Julian O'Neill. Do you have a technical problem? Is there something that needs to be rectified?
Oh, well, obviously, it's the second time it's happened, so I've gone back and spoken to a few of the coaching staff, and basically, I never really run straight at guys, and the other night I was just trying to get to my elbows and knees and get a quick play of the ball so we could go off the back with a quick kick, and as a result, I went in and I thought he was going to come in on the side of my right-hand side, and unfortunately ended up straight in front of me, so it's a bit of mistiming, and I'm just going to have to be a bit more aware of where the bloke is when he's coming into a tackle.
Well, both yourself and Robbie O'Davis missing this afternoon. Not so long ago, you were leading the competition, won a string of games, got some players on the sideline now, talk of Darren Albert going. Fair bit of pressure on the side going into this one. Two losses in a row also.
Yeah, mate, it's pretty indicative of a situation around 95. We really broke the club record then as most consistent wins in a row, and then we missed out in the semis nearly. So we realised the situation here today. It's really do or die for us. And we've got a lot of key players out, but all season we've gone and without a key player in every major game. So we're just really looking forward to getting through the games without Andrew Johns, myself and Robbie O, and hopefully come the big games we'll all be on board and we can put in a good performance.
Your opponents, the Bulldogs, got smashed by 32 points to nil their last start against Canberra. What are your expectations of your opponents this afternoon?
Well, we didn't even look at the tape last week. We really just focused on how good they've been going all year, and you know, they're a form side, and obviously their great strength lies in their forward pack, and a lot of experts believe that's our, you know, weakness. So it's going to be a great test for us here today, particularly the forwards. I feel if they can really stand up and be counted today, I'm sure that we've got enough class out wide to really take care of the opportunities that are on offer.
On a personal level, how do you rate your form?
Oh, mate, in State of Origin, I've been absolutely, you know, really happy with the way I've been going, and, you know, I'm just glad that I've been involved in the series, and obviously haven't been 100% fit this year, but, you know, you can't wait for that to happen, and I'm just really happy with the way I'm going. I'm obviously pretty eager to hold on to my Australian Test jersey, and obviously that's going to come down to what happens in the next Origin, so I just can't wait to bring it on.
Well, mate, good luck for the third State of Origin, and thanks for joining us this morning. No Adam McDougall this afternoon, guys. As we pointed out, a couple of changes from both teams. Julian Bailey goes into the centres for the Knights. For Canterbury, Nigel Vungener pulled out earlier in the week. Shane Martini will start. Glenn Hughes is out of the second row. Willie Mason comes off the bench. He'll be replaced by Dennis Scott. The referee this afternoon is Tim Mander.
Thanks, Pete, and thanks, Adam McDougall, up there at Marathon Stadium. You'll see that game this afternoon on Channel 9 at 4 p.m.
Coming off their worst performance of the season, the Bulldogs have scored their first win in Newcastle in 7 years. 5-8, Braith and Astor with a two-try haul.
Sherwin kicking. El Masri will do it again. El Masri's over again.
But the star of the show was winger Hazem El Masri, who scored 3 tries and kicked 7 goals for a personal tally of 26 points. The Knights thrashed by 24, their coach lamenting the absence of Andrew Johns, Robbie O'Davis and Adam McDougall.
I think there's $1 million sitting on the sideline at the moment in those three players, and there's no question that you would like to have your best players available. That's, we knew that before the game, so you've just got to try and do the best you can without them.
Probably our worst performance by a long shot.
It's very pleasing. It'll make for a much better bus trip home, I can assure you. I'm not pretending to be knowing what's going on at Newcastle, but I think they're just out of form a little bit. You know, it happens. It's going to happen in the 26th round of competition that you go in and out of form 2 or 3 times probably.
About this, tomorrow night at Parramatta Stadium, the Knights are out to stop a 3-game losing streak. Hard to imagine. Newcastle haven't beaten the Eels at home since way back in 1989. That's a long time ago. I guess the Eels, Luke, are they the premiership measuring stick at the moment? They're going good, aren't they?
At the moment, I think for sure, you know, everyone's playing with confidence and a lot of young blokes, and, you know, they're doing the job. So
always worries me with the young side after all the write-ups about beating Brisbane last week, yeah, that they're next week. And Parramatta, if you look through the season, after they've got plenty of raps, they don't seem to perform the next week. Newcastle Knights, is it 4 in a row they're looking at if they lose this
yep,
one?
Yep.
Unheard of, and should be a good game. They really need to lift.
Howell Badiris, a fantastic hooker, very talented, but into the number 7 jumper, Luke. It's a big ask.
Yeah, well, he's a good player. I think he'll handle that, and he's got, you know, quality players around him, so they'll help him out.
I'm glad they put Gidley back to the centres. Yeah, he's found wanting at 5-8 and just wasn't getting...
He's got that beautiful right-hand pass, the way he can slip a ball. It's that playing over on the right-hand side is better than him playing.
I don't know about wanting. I just think there's a little bit too much traffic around him. Yeah. I mean, he's pretty well spotted from every side. You know?
And, of course, no Andrew Johnson at number 7 to take a little bit of pressure off the 5-8 as well there in Gidley.
The Chiefs challenge last week, it went for 3 hours.
Disgraceful.
Over 18 segments. Can we shorten it up a little bit?
We're going to shorten it up and it's back. Chiefs challenge.
Chiefs challenge.
A All right, Robbo last week, he done a pretty good job, but he's gone. No good. I've been thinking about this one all week. It's a big one. Let's get it on.
Bring
Let's
it on. Go. Bring it on. Chiefs Challenge.
All right. Here we go. The ancient art of firewalking takes a lot of mental power. It's a big one. Now, I've got the two contestants ready to go. Come on, boys. Ryan and Tom. How you going, guys? What do you think? Now, are you psyched up for this? Are you psyched up? You ready?
Oh, yeah.
All right, we're going to go through it. Whoever walks through it successfully wins $1,000, thanks to Telstra, which is fantastic. The great supporters of our game. If you both walk through, you get $500. Now, I've got to make the Chiefs Challenge work. It's a big one tonight. So what I'll do, you hold the cash for me, have a look, and I'll do it myself. Now,
are you going to do this?
I'm going to do it. I was told to take my shoes off half an hour before. Julius Marlowe's. Okay.
Show some ticker sheet. Come on, champ. Come on, champ. You can do it, champ.
Stand on that, All right. Okay.
Excellent work,
chief. Give me the cash. All righty. Now.
Friday night, Chief, Para and Newcastle. And this is a very important game for the Knights because it's 3 weeks to go on top of the ladder.
Yeah, you don't go from top of the ladder to lose three in a row without some alarm bells going. It's going to be a massive clash tomorrow night. Look, the Parramatta Eels are white hot. They're probably in their best form, I'd say, for years. And Jason Taylor make a comment to say that's the best team that he's played. And he's played a lot of first-grade games. I think that's a fair call. You can see the ins and outs here. Young Johnny Morris gets a start for Newcastle. Adam McDougall comes in. That's a big plus for us.
And the Parramatta team, which is going great guns. That was a great win against Brisbane last week. They all played so well. And Daniel Waggon, especially in the second half, playing at lock forward. He had a great game, Pete.
Well, I think, you know, the great thing about the performance was especially the second half defence when Brisbane threw absolutely everything at them. And they won that game without Brett Hodgson, who's probably been close to their best in the last few weeks, and Nathan Hindmarsh, who was out injured as well. So the depth at the club is outstanding at the moment. Ben, your guys knocked them off a couple of weeks ago, Newcastle. How do you rate these two sides?
Yeah, Newcastle have lost three in a row, and that doesn't happen too often. So I'd be surprised if they didn't, you know, come out and have a fairly good showing. But they've still got a very good side. They've made a few changes in the halves there with Badiris going to halfback, so that may add a bit of stability to the team. And yeah, they certainly need Johns back in the team, but he'll be back there in a couple of weeks, and it'll be a strong team once again.
You're dead right there. Rudder back to 5'8 is good, and also Gidley to centre. That's where he enjoys playing the most. So that'll add a bit more stability to that side.
You're solid there, Chief. You're
mate, always hack with the boys. Look, it's happened before. The middle of the season, it seems that teams that with the most reason to win get up. And Newcastle were embarrassed after last week, and I wouldn't be surprised if they'd done something special on tomorrow.
Jace, what about the forward power of both of these packs?
Yeah, mate, particularly Parramatta.
Because they flogged you down at Toyota Park a while ago.
Yep, they dominated us. We had a win against them, a tough win in the first round, but you know, you got to take your hat off to Nathan Cale, to Michael Vella. Yeah. They're really, really taking it to them up the centre, and you know, two outstanding young front rowers, yeah, mate. I think that's where their real strength lies, but they've got a great balance across the field as well.
Look, they are a good side. Sterling, you said last week that they've got a lot of representative players, particularly in the forwards, but the Newcastle Knights backline, a lot of those guys have played representative football the last two or three weeks. I think they could be the key for the Newcastle Knights. But one bloke in particular, Ben Kennedy, I think he's been playing sensational football. He's stepped it up again since he was dropped for New South Wales. He's been a great player.
Oh, no doubt, and he was outstanding in a boot inside. But you know, you mentioned Andrew Johns, and actually, I think we're going across to Joey up there.
Yeah, well, what's happened up in Newcastle? Billy Pete and Robbie have got a brand new surf shop up there, and Joey's up there right now. Come in, Joey. What's doing up there in Newcastle?
Thanks, Fatty. I'm here at Newcastle's newest surf store, which is owned by Robbie O'Davis and Billy Pooden, and they're here, so I'll have a quick word to them. Billy, you and Robbie, marketing whizzes, you've come up with a great name for the store, The Surf Shop. How long did it take you to get that name?
Yeah, a lot of long sleepless nights, mate. Obviously pretty similar to the footy show.
And, probably in a way. When's the store open?
It's opening tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock, so we're having a bit of a sale for the first week. No clothing over $50, so get down and buy some gear.
Beautiful. And just on footy, we'll thump last week at home, the Bulldogs. How are we going to turn around versus Red Hot Eels, especially down there at Parramatta?
Yeah, that was pretty embarrassing last week, so we're looking to get out there and be very passionate and enthusiastic, and we think we can turn it around that way.
So do I. Good on you, Billy. And here's Knights injured fullback, Bobby Boucher, Robbie Owl. Mate, the shot looks good. Must be pretty happy with it.
Mate, it's come up really big, Joe. Very happy, and it's exciting times. I wish I was playing football to go along with it.
Yeah. Now, where's it located? Where can you find the surf shop?
Mate, it's in the Katara Homemaker Centre in between JB's Hi-Fi and the Strathfield Car Radio.
Oh, beautiful. And, mate, you don't mind if I sort of take a dozen or so jumpers home with me, do you?
Mate, that's what we're all about here. You can take home all those jumpers, and not only that, you can take home a surfboard, which we've got especially for you here. Billy, hold that one for you, mate. Oh, there you go, Joe. I've even signed it up for you. When you get a little bit better, you can come in. We'll give you a decent one. That'll start you off.
Good quality gear, actually.
It is, mate.
Actually, I wanted to ask you. I was shopping yesterday for my father's birthday, and I was looking for a jumper. And I was at Lowe's and some Vinnies, but I think you've got them. It's good quality gear,
mate. We're all about good quality gear, low prices.
Lovely. And who we got over here? Let's have a look at Big Shazza Albert. Darren, look, don't be fooled by this. I walked in earlier, and he didn't have shirts. He was over there in the bikini section, and he had a pink, fluffy pair, and they were over his head. They weren't on hangers. You're kidding, are you? You haven't been hanging up shirts.
Mate, yeah, well, you know, the bikini thing, that's just a bit of a fetish of mine, and I try to do it at home in private, not out in public.
Yeah, I can understand that. You live in Robbie O, so you're working here for nothing. Is that right?
Yeah. So this is hard work, 40 hours a week. You know, I'm doing a hard job, except for training, so this is how I pay for my rent.
And wingers, mate, I've got to ask you. I've always wondered, I can never get you, so I never tackle you. You're so fast and elusive. Is it because you're born with all that fast twitch, or you train for it, or is it just when you get the ball, you all just shit yourself? What is it?
It's got to be a combination of all those things, but, whatever it is, it's working because you can't catch us, so that's about the best we've got.
Thanks, Albie. Well, there you have it, boys. We're going to give Parramatta a go. We're going to cross to them now, and down there at Parramatta is Nathan Kalis and David Vialecki. How you going, boys? What's going
on? Yeah, we're good. I just had a tough training session and looking forward to a big game tomorrow night.
Well, boys, you have a name, Brett Hodgson or Nathan Highmarsh. Are you going to spring any surprises on us?
Nah, I don't think so. I think it's going to be still as per program. Yeah.
What about you, Joe? Are you going to slip the jumper on and run out there?
Oh, I can't say too much, boys, but the bloke who runs out number 7, he might be having 90 kilos tomorrow night. But what about you, blokes? You've won 10 in a row. How's Brian Smith keep you up? Viagra?
This guy does. He loves it.
Nah, it's just been good at the moment. Everyone's really confident and, there's a good feeling in camp at the moment. So, we're looking forward to another big game tomorrow night. Hey, Fresh.
Yeah, mate. Hopefully.
Well, Nath, there's been talk that you could be Parramatta's best ever prop. How do you handle those sort of... Here he is. Look, mate. You're sick. Get to the toilet and do what you got to do and just leave me alone. The best ever prop, there's been talk that you could be Parramatta's best ever prop. How do you handle those sort of raps?
I don't know. They're not too comfortable with me. It's a bit embarrassing. But, I think Mick Vella would have a lot to say about that as well. He's playing really well. You just try and go out there and play your best footy, as you know. So, I'll just be going out there tomorrow night and giving it my best shot.
Yeah, Brian Smith's known for his great game plans. What secrets have you got to stop the Newcastle Knights this week?
Mate, we're not going to let any secrets out at this stage, so you'll just have to do your best.
Come on, I won't say anything.
Yeah, Joey, I think Brian would be a bit angry with us if we tell you, but it's going to be a real tough game. What do you think, Nath?
Yeah, it is going to be really tough. I know both teams are looking forward to it, and we'll just have to be on our game tomorrow night, so it should be a good one.
Well, there you have it, boys. Thanks for turning up.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Joey. Hopefully we'll see you back on the field soon. Take it easy.
Thanks, mate. See ya.
I've got my fingers crossed. I think the Knights can go down tomorrow night at Paris Stadium and cause an upset. I'll be there watching. I think she's on telly at 8:30. So I've got my board here, free from Robbie O. So thanks a lot, mate. And it's back to you in the studio, Fatty.
Thanks, Joey. Thanks, Joey. And you'll see that game tomorrow night. Parramatta take on the Newcastle side. Ray Warren back in action, 8:30 p.m.
And thanks to Joey, to Nathan and David as well. Good work, boys. Now look, Lady Luck time, and the lovely, gorgeous Dee Sparch is out at Sydney Children's Hospital for Lady Luck.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to a very special evening of Lady Luck. It's special because I'm surrounded by all these beautiful kids at the Sydney Children's Hospital, Randwick. Everybody say hello.
Hello.
And it's for these kids that we're hopefully making their lives a little bit easier by raising this money for. I've got Michael here, and he's just had an operation last night. What a brave boy. How are you, Michael?
I'm all right.
That's the way. And who do you barrack for?
I go for the Broncos.
Not happy about that. And Natalie, who do you barrack for? Sharks. Go to Sharks. And I've got a whole lot of Knight supporters here. Cheeky little monkeys, aren't they? I can see. Who's your favourite player?
Andrew Johns.
Go Andrew Johns. Excellent. Okay, well, let's all have a look at the prices for this week. In tomorrow night's big game, it's the On Fire Eels at $1.28 with the Out of Sort Knights at $3.30. Come on, Joey, we need you back. Over the page and in the Channel 9 TV game at North Power Stadium, it's Take Your Pick with the Eagles and Bulldogs both at $1.85.
Yeah.
How are you going there? You winning?
Yep.
Good boy. Excellent. Well, we're having a lot of fun here, but now it's time to play some bets. And thanks to Sports Tab, we have another $1,000 to play with. So let's have a look at what we picked.
I'll squirt it at you.
Right, so how can I not have something on the Knights, even without Joey? So I'm going to have $500 on the Knights. And with the other $500, I don't mind the 11.5 start the Cowboys have against the Panthers. Okay, kids, who are you going to be barracking for this weekend?
The Knights!
That's like a lot of Knights. How about you, Hayley?
The Newcastle Knights.
Yay, good girl. And how about you,
Sinead? The Newcastle Knights.
They're everywhere. Look, with support like this, I just know we're going to have some winners this week. I can tell. Okay, that's it from me. Have fun. Until next week, remember, Lady Luck is on your side.
Thanks very much. Dee, Smart, you've had a blinder. Great job out there with those kids, and thanks very much for your time away from Water Rats. Now, going from strength to strength in the boxing caper. Good win there, and I think he's headed overseas now. Is he for his next fight?
Yeah, I think so.
Mate, now that you're third host, you've got to know these things.
I know, I'm just a junior host, but I should know that, but it was a great fight. He's proven himself, no doubt.
Did you go?
I didn't go, no, but I watched it on TV. It was great.
You saw nothing, did you?
No.
Did you?
I did, of course.
Excellent. Excellent bullshitting. That's all we like on this show.
And sport now with Billy Woods and a danger game for the Eels.
Yes, but a very, very exciting game it should be, Jessica. Beware of the Knights, that's what they're saying, and we'll have more on that match shortly. Rugby league firstly, and the blue and gold juggernaut just rolls on tonight. The informed Parramatta face a Newcastle side still without Andrew Johns. Tony Peters joins us from Parramatta Stadium. Tony, any late changes?
Yes, Billy, the Bulldogs have lost... Newcastle Knights have lost Paul Marquette off the bench, and he's been replaced by the local boy up there called John Morris. Andrew Johns made a late effort to try and play this game, but the Knights doctor ruled him out until the following match, which comes up against the Broncos in a fortnight's time. As for Parramatta, well, maybe their special guest here, our fullback Brett Hodgson, the injured fullback, may be able to tell us. Brett, what's the situation with the Eels?
We're as per program tonight, so looking for a big game.
OK, now you're injured at the moment with a fractured finger. What's the situation?
I had an operation early midweek last week, and I had the tendon repaired, so hopefully I will be back for the Warriors game in a couple of weeks.
You've been the form player for Parramatta in recent weeks?
I've been quite happy with how I've been playing, but we've had some outstanding players of late, Nathan Callis, and guys such as him have been going real well, so the team's real happy at the moment.
10 games without a loss, is the pressure mounting?
I don't think so. I think it'd be more so if we had 10 games without a win, so it's good to be winning, and hopefully we can keep that rolling tonight.
Yeah, this is a real danger game tonight. I mean, they spanked you in the first round.
Yeah, they gave us a bit of a touch-up, but we haven't actually talked about that midweek, and hopefully we can get one back and see how we go.
And just finally, is it good getting them without Andrew Johns?
It is, yeah. It's always a bonus if you're playing them without Andrew Johns. He's one of the best players in the world, obviously, and hopefully they will miss him tonight. And
hello.
We'll be right.
Thanks for joining us. Good luck in your comeback.
Thank you.
Bill.
Tony, it's not just, of course, the absence of Johns, but the Eels are so hard to beat at home as well.
Yes, the Knights haven't got a bad record overall, though, against the Parramatta Eels. If you look at the record overall, Bill, the 22 matches, the honours are fairly much even. But back here at Parramatta Stadium is where the Eels stand out. They've played the 10 matches, the Eels have won 7, and one, of course, has been drawn, so the Eels very dominant here at Parramatta Stadium. But some other statistics become very relevant here, Bill. Newcastle haven't won here since 1989. Now, if memory serves me correctly, that's 7 matches. Parramatta's last loss here was in round 2, and it took a field goal by the Sharks to do that. And then, of course, if you look at the Eels' last loss in the Premiership, that was in round 6, and that was against the Canberra Raiders, 22-6. So a very, very informed Parramatta side, Bill.
Well, it won't be long before you get swamped by the crowd there, Tony.
War between league and union has been avoided for the time being, with the NRL refusing to allow clubs to poach high-profile players from rugby. Friday Night Football finds the Newcastle Knights desperate to end a 3-match losing streak. They're up against Parramatta, who are leading the competition and back on home territory.
Currently on top of the table, the Eels keep reminding themselves that the climb is not complete until September, and against Newcastle, they can't afford to plateau.
You just can't look past that. You know, I've been in similar situations before, and there's a lot to go, and we've just got to keep our head down.
We're the one that's the current flavour of the month. We want to stay that way if we can for a couple more.
Out to end their 3-match losing streak, the Knights will start regular hooker Danny Badouris at halfback.
A bit rusty last week. I had a few minutes there. So mate, this week I know I'm going to be playing halfback, so I really focus on it.
Rugby league first, and Parramatta and Newcastle are both genuine premiership contenders, but at the moment, that's about all they have in common. While competition leaders Parramatta are on a hot streak of wins, the Knights have gone cold. Steve Hart is at Parramatta Stadium.
Thanks very much, Leanne. Well, the Parramatta fans were treated to an awesome display here tonight at Parramatta Stadium by the Eels. They were just relentless in the forwards. Newcastle hasn't beaten Parramatta on their home turf since 1989, and nothing changed tonight. Plenty of controversy early, and coach Michael Hagan came into this game trying to break the form slump since losing Andrew Johns back in round 11 against the Dragons by moving hooker Danny Badouris into the number 7 position.
With Andrew Johns sidelined by injury, regular hooker Danny Badouris, Newcastle's latest halfback experiment. Some desperate cleaning up from Knights fullback Mark Hughes halted an early Parramatta raid, but the visitors couldn't stop a runaway Brad Drew.
Drew puts a kick in for the corner. They're going to do it. They have done it.
4-0 the Eels, and Newcastle centre Tamana Tahu threw a surprise ball. David Vialecki hit back.
Well, there's a better push in charge.
But the next blow really hurt the Knights. The video referee controversially ruling captain Bill Peden knocked on, robbing Newcastle of their first points. The competition frontrunners in a punishing mood. Point scoring machine Jason Taylor a slippery eel, sparking another blue and green attack as Parramatta charged to a 10-0 lead. Referee Sean Hampstead missed Daniel Wagon's knock-on, but the Knights were comprehensively outplayed. Taylor crossing and also becoming only the second player in history to score 2,000 points in first grade.
Second player in rugby league premiership history.
In the second 40, not even Newcastle Ironman Ben Kennedy could break the Eels' brick wall defence.
That is outstanding defence.
Great offence. Michael Vella.
Before Taylor's magical boot brought more points. Parramatta continued the massacre as the Knights self-destructed. Jamie Lyons kicked finding runaway winner Scott Donald 34-0.
Donald is flying! I think he's done it!
Eels confirming their standing as dual premiership favourites with an incredible 7-0 whitewash of the Knights.
There he goes, beautiful dive. Well done, Jamie Lyons.
So the final score, 40-0 to Parramatta. Luke Burt crossing for a hat-trick of tries. Andrew Ryan, Jason Taylor, Scott Donald and Jamie Lyon also crossing for 4-pointers. 5 from 7 for Jason Taylor in the goals. Luke Burt kicked 1 from 1. And Jason Taylor battered and bruised from a couple of high shots he took throughout the game, passing that milestone of 2,000 points and just happy to be part of another great Parramatta win.
Thanks. I'm feeling better than I look. I'm scared to look in the mirror, so I haven't done that.
But it is very difficult in a game of football at this level nowadays to zero another team. There's a lot of effort goes into that and a lot of pride, and I thought they showed that right from the start.
Yes, it was 40-0, and yes, Parramatta played well, and yes, we're not travelling as well as we'd like to, but we'll go from that one without sour grapes, mind you, and then we'll go forward pass on the next try for Parramatta, then we'll go knock on in the lead up to the next try, which was a kick. That's 16 points or 18 points. So when you're not travelling that well, our team didn't deserve to be behind 24-0 at half time.
Andrew Johns makes a long-awaited return from a knee injury this weekend. The Newcastle star is raring to go, even putting his hand up to play halfback for Australia against New Zealand next week.
He hasn't received the SOS yet, but Andrew Johns wants the test selectors to know he can be their Alan Langer.
You know, I'd jump at the chance to play halfback for Australia. I've only played two games there throughout my career.
With Queensland's hero headed back to Warrington, the selectors must decide between an out-of-form Brett Camorley, who's test coach Chris Anderson's preferred option, and Johns, who hasn't played since he injured his knee back in April. Johns returns for Newcastle against Brisbane on Friday night.
I've just got to get through Friday night and hopefully play dominant and just show the selectors and Chris Anderson that I am ready to play.
Rated the best player in the world, Johns says fitness won't be a problem and all he lacks is confidence.
You know, confidence can be that fragile sometimes that, you know, I just got to get back to that confidence I had before I got injured, where every time I got the ball, I thought I could break the line.
For Newcastle supporters, Friday night's game against Brisbane will mark the return of the Messiah. It's been almost 10 weeks since halfback Andrew Johns tore a ligament in his knee. Now he's ready to get the Knights' premiership campaign back on track.
Regarded in many league quarters as the best player in the world, Andrew Johns can't wait to once again ply his trade.
You know, confidence can be that fragile sometimes that, you know, I just got to get back to that confidence I had before I got injured, where every time I got the ball I thought I could break the line.
It was against Newcastle in round 11. Johns went down in a painful heat, and Newcastle didn't have long to wait to realise just how much they would miss him. Leading by 18 points before Johns was hurt, the Knights eventually beat a fast-finishing St George Illawarra by 8. With Johns calling the shots, Newcastle was also the competition leader. The Knights have now lost their last four and are sitting fifth on the table.
The fire's really burning now. I'm just dying to get back out there.
Johns has been back in full training for 4 weeks and he believes the Broncos will provide the ultimate test for his injury. Newcastle will also be strengthened by the return of Robbie O'Davis.
For us to turn our form around, we're going to go out there and have to give these blokes a hide, and otherwise we might as well write the year off.
It's not quite that desperate. After this weekend, there are still 8 rounds before the finals. Clinton Fletcher, National 9 News.
Rugby league now. Newcastle has named Andrew Johns in Friday night's team to play Brisbane. The eagerly awaited return of Johns comes just days before the Australian team is named for the test against New Zealand. But will Johns wear the number 7 for the Kangaroos? Here's Steve Hart.
Well, that's the $64,000 question, Tim. You can bet it's going to be a heated battle around the selection table on Sunday afternoon. The coach wants Brett Camorley in the number 7. The other selectors are preferring Johns. Look, he'll definitely be in the side somewhere, and he made it quite clear today where he wants that to be.
I'd jump at the chance to play halfback for Australia. I've only played 2 games there throughout my career, so I wouldn't mind a few more number 7 Australian jerseys in my closet.
But Chris Anderson is a man who usually gets his way, so Johns may have to wait for another time before he gets another green and gold number 7. It's quite amazing. Andrew Johns has missed 6 NRL games through that knee injury, and he still leads the Dally M Player of the Year awards. It's incredible stuff, and it just shows you how good he was going before that injury happened. Can he turn it around for Newcastle against the Broncos on Friday night? It's a big ask. Johns is only focusing on one thing.
Confidence can be that fragile sometimes that, you know, I just got to get back to that confidence I had before I got injured, where every time I got the ball, I thought I could break the line.
Watch out, Brisbane, if he can get that confidence back early. The Knights are also boosted by the return of Robbie O'Davis. While Wayne Bennett has named all 10 State of Origin players in his team for Friday night, Darren Lockyer, captain, isn't concerned that they may be a little flat after the highs of Sunday night.
The worst thing that could happen to us maybe was play a lesser team away. You know, it would have been hard to get motivated for it, but, you know, marathon Friday night, you don't get much bigger tests in the NRL than that.
Of course, Wimbledon's happening. Matty John's one of our favourite ever people to come on this show, and he's over playing for Wigan at the moment. He's come down to London from Wigan with a bloke called Brian Carney, who's a teammate of his. He's an Irish teammate playing with Wigan, and he's their report at Wimbledon.
Matthew John's here. It was always my dream to compete centre court at Wimbledon. Politics and lack of ability denied me that chance. But I'm here today with my friend Brian Carney. We're going to ask the locals what they think of Australian tennis players. George Negus, nice to meet you. I just want to ask you, what do you think about the Australian tennis players?
Well,
We are forbidden to answer anything about.
You know, I used to live next door to Bjorn Borg, actually.
Did you?
And, geez, he was fit. You know, he'd run all day and he'd make love all night, Bjorn. I reckon he used to like a bit of this stuff, but, mate, what a bloke. What do you think about the Australian tennis players?
Not a lot bad, really. Not very familiar with the tennis at all, but I think they're excellent.
You know, Merv Hughes is probably one of my favourites. What about yourself? Hey, I used to date the Williams sisters. Yeah, Venus and Serena. Taught them everything they know. You know, their old man, he's mistaken, he's a really nice guy. Great guy. Great sisters, actually. Great athletes. Yeah, great lovers. Yeah. Well, we're privileged to have a couple of American friends here, and it is the 4th of July.
It is. Happy 4th of July.
Yes, my word. 4th of July, huh?
Yes.
4th of July.
Yep.
It is the 4th of July.
It's the 4th of July.
Ah, how good is it?
Very good.
Yeah. 4th. 4th of the 7th.
Yeah, 7th of the 4th, I hear.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, there seems to be a bit of trouble here.
I qualify today. Where I go? Mixed doubles.
Mixed doubles?
Yeah. Mixed doubles court 15. Yeah,
I think the mixed doubles you're on will be the one in the park.
You want to play mixed doubles?
On the municipal courts just over there.
You want to play doubles?
Do I want to play doubles with you?
Yeah.
I'll play doubles with you, but not mixed doubles with you.
Well, I play love for a man's bottom.
I think that's a no. Who's got the best serve in tennis? I don't know about that. I actually slipped into the men's change room and saw the Scuds missile. And let me tell you, it's pretty impressive. Okay, is Tim Henman gay?
No!
That's a big yes. Have you got anything you'd like to say to your father, Paul?
No, that's okay.
Do you see him much?
No.
Do you watch him on the footy show?
No.
Does he embarrass you?
Yeah.
Give me a hug. Okay. Okay. Just, okay. Yep. Yeah. Thank you. We might just cut that. Well, that's it from Brian and myself here today at Wimbledon. The Aussies have been making a huge impression, as I'm sure my brother Andrew will tomorrow night in his comeback game at Marathon Stadium against the Broncos. Good luck, Joey.
Matty Johns, you idiot. Well done, and thanks for that with Brian Carney there, who's a bit of a character. Robbo's back with the street talk. He's been out in the streets of Newcastle. Of course, the big match tomorrow night, it's the comeback of Andrew Johns and Robbie O'Davis. And Robbo's caught up with all the people in Newcastle.
This Friday night heralds the return of the night saviour. No, not me, Mr. Vorton. Joey Johns. Can he save the Knights and put the season back on track with Robbie O? Let's see.
Can Joey save the Knights, mate?
My word, he can.
You think the Knights can beat the Broncos?
I think he can, yeah.
Is he their saviour?
My word, he is.
You think him and Robbie O will get the Knights back on track?
I don't know yet, mate. They better pick their four, won't they?
They'll be glad to see Robbie and Andrew back.
Why wasn't he playing for the Blues?
Well, he's pregnant, mate.
Is he?
Oh, his wife is pregnant.
Oh, yeah. Was it? Oh, yeah. Right. Okay.
Yeah. Hello. Do you think Andrew Johns can save the Knights? Do you think he can save the Knights? But do you think he can save the Knights? Will you be at the game?
No, unfortunately, I won't be there.
Do you want a ticket?
Ticket, I haven't got money.
Right.
The Steel City town, the town that means something to the Knights, and the Knights mean something to the town, so they're going to get there, absolutely.
You've been rehearsing, mate.
No.
You're on fire. Do you want to feel that? What do you think?
It's pretty good.
You like it?
You got some.
Thank you. Oh, I've got something.
You got something?
Huh? Think yeah. I could play for the Knights?
Oh, I think so.
What do you like about me?
You could be the ball.
Do you think Andrew Johns can save the Knights?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, why?
Well, I think he's a great ball distributor and he'll get the ball out there. It hasn't been happening.
So you're thinking he's pretty good handling the ball?
Yeah, I know. He's obviously good handling the ball.
You're not a cheerleader, are you?
No, no.
You dance at my place any night, darling.
Thanks.
With your little fluffy.
Oh, okay.
Are they a one-man team?
Yeah.
Yeah? Who?
Knight.
Yeah.
You make me out look like a dick.
No, no, no. You think he's the best halfback in the world? Where are you off to, mate? The cricket?
No. All right.
Do you know Fatty Vorton?
Fatty. Yes, I know him, the redhead.
Yeah. You rate the fat?
If I watch the fat, yeah, I do.
You like the fat?
I like the fat. Yes, I do.
You do like fat.
Yeah. It's a bit red for me.
Yeah. Oh, a bit red.
He's a bit red for me.
Single-handedly, do you think Andrew Johns can turn their season around?
Sure.
Mate, I wasn't finished. Mate, I wasn't finished, please. How are you? Just going home from work?
Yep, sure I am.
I've often seen you in my street. You've been stalking me.
Oh, just look at in your bathroom window.
I know that.
Is that good enough for you? Do you want me to talk on the microphone? Yep. I don't know what to say. Sorry. It's so funny, this guy.
Well, as you can see, Fat, it's past knock-off time here. Everyone in Newcastle knows the Knights need Andrew Johns like the Seagulls needed that quick, red-headed tackling machine from Queensland. Fat, everyone in Newcastle saying, bring on the Broncos!
Thank you. Well done. Just before we go on to the Friday night game, Gus, we've got to... Oh, there's the game there. As we go on to that Friday night game, the Knights take on the Broncos there tomorrow night. It'll be a great night at Marathon Stadium. And ins and outs, you can see the boys that are back. Go Davis, Johns, Marquette and Clinton O'Brien's back. And Tohu Donaldson, Newton and John Morris out. And for the Broncos, no changes at this stage, although there's doubts over Lockyer and possibly Shane Webke.
And Chief, this is just about the strongest side the Knights could name. Tahu out for 6 weeks with the problems with his calves.
Mm-hmm.
But
that's right.
They've got to show something tomorrow night after their last couple of performances.
Yeah, I think for tomorrow night, after four losses in a row, I don't think it's about winning or losing now, or winning the game, because it's been a long time since we've just played well. I think they just need to concentrate on a solid performance. A lot of pressure being put on Andrew Johns. But the fact of the matter is he will make the difference. Like, just his kicking game and his organisational stuff alone, Robbie O coming in is a big plus. But I'd just like to see us play well. We haven't actually played well for a long time, and the winning will take care of itself. But it's going to be a big challenge. They're going to track down a great team, the Brisbane Broncos, whether or not they've got some guys injured. The young thoroughbreds are a top-quality side. So after Parramatta last week, it's a big challenge for us. And I just want to see us improve.
Well, their biggest problem, of course, Gus, will be State of Origin hangover. How they handle that. I think so far after the two State of Origins, they've had one loss and one draw.
Yeah, their performances haven't been that bad, though, Fatty. They were down 26-10 against the Raiders, but came home for a 26-all draw. They played particularly well against Parramatta. Parramatta were just too good on the night, but that game was in the balance with 20 minutes to go. And they've got an outstanding record against Newcastle. Now, I think the fact they haven't won a game after Origin is a nice way for Wayne Bennett to come in on Tuesday morning and say, I've got a challenge for you. Yep. And I think they'll rise to it. They've risen to everything else been thrown at them this year, both at club and representative level. In something like 19 games against the Knights, the Broncos have won 15 times. They've got a terrific record against them. They flogged them in round one. Andrew Johns played on that night. And at Marathon Stadium, I think this is the challenge that Wayne Bennett will set them. We haven't won a game after Origin. Come up for me one more time and they'll do it.
Yeah, it should be a great one. Make sure you tune in tomorrow night to watch that one. All right then. Now, Chief,
yes.
There's a brand new competition concerning the Knights. Tell us all about it.
Yeah, very special competition to be a Knight for a week. Basically, the lucky winner will spend a whole week with the Newcastle Knights. The climax of the prize week seeing the winner and a partner join the boys on a jet to Townsville for 2 days. They also get to be a special reporter for our show, including on the plane trip north. They'll file a report in the following week's footy show. To enter the competition, simply dial 1-900-966-558 to register. The winner will be announced on the 15th of August. Once you register, the punters will also have a chance to win weekly prizes at the Knights games as well. And all the funds raised will go to the John Hunter Hospital, which is a great cause. So it's a pretty good competition. I think you'll enjoy it, and it's going to a great cause.
Yeah, good stuff. And the Newcastle Knights always look after their own.
Friday night football sees the Knights at home to the Broncos. The last meeting between good mates and arch rivals Adam McDougall and Wendell Saylor before the Brisbane winger switches to rugby union.
Obviously, we've had some great battles, and hopefully I can get over the top of him for this last time.
Tomorrow, it's the Dragons against the Raiders, the Warriors and the Eels, and the Cowboys play the Sharks. On Sunday, the Roosters take on the Eagles and the Bulldogs host the Panthers. Andrew McKinlay, National 9 News.
Big question mark, the big debate on Sunday night, judging by coach Chris Anderson, will be the halfback position. If Andrew Johns pulls up okay in his comeback game tonight, he must be and wants to be selected as the test half.
Yeah, I'd love to. I think if I'm probably all goes to show how I play Friday night. If I play well, then I might be a chance. But, I'd jump at the chance to play halfback for Australia. I've only played two games there throughout my career, so You know, I wouldn't mind a few more than other seven Australian jerseys in my closet. If my form's good Friday night, I know in my own self that my fitness will be fine. But, you know, I've just got to get through Friday night and hopefully play dominant and just show the selectors and Chris Anderson that I am ready to play. And, you know, hopefully if I give him a chance, I know I won't let no one down. But, you know, I always say anywhere in the 17 would be nice, but it'd be extra special to have number seven.
No doubt about that. 11 games in the test jumper, only two as the halfback. The biggest game of the season kicks off in 30 minutes' time, roughly. Newcastle at home to Brisbane. Andrew Johns is back. The marathon will be rocking here, and Newcastle get half a point start. It won't be easy because Newcastle and Brisbane both have plenty of players backing up. Brisbane have 10 backing up. In round five, it was Brisbane 42-8. Brad Mears comes back into this side for the Brisbane Broncos. 10 players backing
on top of the premiership, the Newcastle Knights, when Andrew Johns left, now sitting in fifth position, and really a tough patch for them. A lot of expectation on Andrew Johns tonight. We're all expecting him to play well, but if they're ever going to beat Brisbane Broncos, it should be tonight after they're backing up after the Origin.
But I know the paramount of the favourites, but after that State of Origin, you know, I'm just wondering who's going to beat the Broncos. Mm. These kids are just going to get better. And they've done it without Gordon Tallis, so I don't care how good Andrew Johns is.
I think it'll happen tonight, actually. I think Newcastle will win. I reckon that the Brisbane, they're on the breakfast creek, on the syrup there at the breakfast creek.
On the wave of emotion. Day,
and that Joey Johns will be absolutely desperate.
Do you think Wayne Bennett will have him on the syrup? Turn it up.
No, mate. I think Wayne Bennett probably...
You think he had one himself?
He overfeasted on Mars bars. There we go.
I can tell you what, he's been working very hard. He's never been the best trainer in the world, Andrew Johns, but since he's been out, it's been 10 long weeks. He's been working very hard on his fitness. At a pinch, he could have played in the last round against Parramatta. He gave himself some extra time for the Australian selectors, so they'd pick him as halfback. So
when you see him play, he's the sort of player that loves playing. Andrew Johns loves it. It doesn't matter whether he trains or not. He's just born to play
but
football.
But he's a great player, isn't he? Like, you know, it's interesting to say that he thinks that they've got to really bash the Broncos up this week. I don't think it's going to happen.
Well, Andrew Johns.
I'm just going with you, Arthur.
It's good to know, though, isn't it? It's going to be a fantastic game. Andrew Johns fired up for his return match.
When you come back from any major injury, you're always in the back of your mind a bit worried how it's going to go. So, now a lot of people are sort of talking about my fitness. Well, my fitness is going to be fine because I've trained really hard in the past 6 weeks. It's just, confidence can be that fragile sometimes that... You know, I just got to get back to that confidence I had before I got injured, where every time I got the ball, I thought I could break the line. So it's just a matter of building that confidence up again. And that might come with a good tackle, a good pass or a good kick. So hopefully it'll only take a couple of minutes.
When it's all said and done, they've got a responsibility to play well in their own right. So irrespective of what Andrew brings to the football team, they've got their own job. Do not expect them to do their job better than they've been doing the last couple of weeks.
Every game I go out, I get targeted. You know, I hear teams saying run at him, tire him out, and they try to, in a way, wound me so I'm not playing. So it's just a part of the game I have to realise now. And I'm lucky the forwards look after me. There's times they protect me. So it's just a matter of trying to keep myself out of danger, out of the big boys. But I'm sure I'll be seeing the likes of Myers and Dane Cale all charging at me throughout the night. So I'm looking forward. It's a good challenge, so can't wait.
Yeah, won't worry him too much. The loss of Johns has sadly affected the Knights. From competition leaders, the Knights are now in fifth on the ladder. That's the sort of difference a star player makes to a side. The stats have turned around completely there. The success rate without Johns, just 1 in 3 games.
Oh, it's not only his defence or his organisation in attack, but it's his kicking game. He can ensure that a side spends a lot of its time trying to get out of its own quarter.
And don't forget his goal kicking too.
Yeah.
He's just got the all-round game, hasn't he? He's the most valuable player in the game, will he? Mm.
Arthur, what about the Broncos? They've got 10 players backing up. We saw Shane Webke. He limped off the field in the Origin. Yes. He's okay to play. He's been training. Darren Lockyer also we saw take a shoulder injury into the game and cop a bad head knock.
You know, it surprises me because when Webke came off, I thought he'd be at least 2 weeks, and the same with Darren Lockyer. I thought that maybe Bennett might have rested him, but this is an important match. He sees it as a crunch match, and I think he's got a job in his hands because I think they're going to target him, especially Webke and them.
He's great for the young blokes, Arthur. A bloke like Webke is on camera now. He turns up to play every week.
Mate, a true professional, isn't he?
Yeah.
One player I don't think we've given enough credit to in our show so far is Lockyer. God, I reckon he's a brave and our resourceful and skillful.
You go
player.
Back to that second State of Origin. You know, I know that they voted for
he's
Trent Barrett and everything.
Field,
but that's what I always said. I said, if Darren Lockyer would have played for New South Wales, he'd have won man of the match hands down.
Well, for the Broncos coach, Wayne Bennett, backing up against the Knights is just another challenge for his club.
Yeah, well, for me personally, it hasn't been tough, but I suppose for the players, it has been. You know, they've something part of something very special, and I was too. So I'm not downplaying that, but you know, I'm more experienced than they are at it, and I've got a different role than what they have. Oh no, I'm not surprised anymore with what these young guys can achieve. You know, it's just the environment's good. That you know, they've got football's the only thing they have to worry about these days, and they just come up and seem to develop a lot quicker than they had in the past. We're not killing them with training, that's a real issue, and you know, we've all learnt over the years about those things, so we're just trying to keep them as fresh as we can, not over-train them, not long periods of time on the training field, and you know, just more concentrating on their playing. But after the next week, we'll get ourselves back into a good routine, but it's still going to be 2 or 3 weeks away before everyone's going to be jumping out of their skins again.
It's been a big week. It's going to be a fantastic atmosphere. Kickoff not too far away there at Marathon Stadium. Pick up on NRL winners, the Premiership's 10,000th game as we go to the break with Knights coach Michael Hagan.
I think there's probably some comparison to be drawn from Alan Langer and the involvement he had last week, but I think you know we're back to a club stage now. The Origin's been, it's probably had more interest in it than an Origin for a lot of years. So I think the focus is just to get ourselves back, focus on the last 9 games of the comp and put ourselves in a position where we can be in the top 4 and go on from there.
After 10 long weeks on the sidelines, the return tonight of the game's premier halfback, Andrew Johns. And his timing couldn't have been better. His out-of-form Newcastle side hosting premiers Brisbane.
If the reception was any indication, Brisbane faced a daunting task as they travelled to Marathon Stadium. Newcastle fans welcoming back their favourite son, Andrew Johns, after being sidelined with a knee injury. The test halfback didn't take long to break the shackles, setting up Robbie O'Davis to get the home side off to the start they needed.
Ladder brushes away. Newcastle in support. O'Davis. Rob O'Davis. He's in to score.
It was clear to see the Knights meant business, the skipper capping off a fairy tale return.
Inside for Johns. Johns is over. Andrew Johns is over. Or maybe he isn't Marathon, the great man.
With 10 players backing up from Origin duties, even an Alan Langer curtain call wouldn't have rejuvenated the visitors. And when 5'8 Sean Rutter made it a 22-point ball game at half-time, the Broncos were in trouble.
They've isolated Saylor, and away it goes to Hughes, back on the inside. Rutter, Rutter's over. This is fantastic.
Andrew Johns continued to write the script after the break, his world-class return continuing into the second half.
Then away from Peden. Peden away for Johns. Joey's over again.
All Wayne Bennett could do was witness the rampage. The Knights white hot as centre Mark Hughes put the match beyond doubt.
Johns looking for Rudder, finding Hughes.
The Johns-led Knights hammering the visitors, Brisbane suffering their worst loss in Premiership history.
And that is an extraordinary scoreline. Andrew Johns almost certainly playing his way straight into the Australian team for next week's test against New Zealand. He set up 6 tries for his teammates, scored 2 of his own, and kicked 6 goals for good measure.
Unbelievable. Unbelievably good from him and from the team, I thought.
I was really confident. I thought we'd beat him. But, yeah, they're really ripe, I think, coming off a big win like that. And I would have done a little bit of celebrating, I suppose. The pleasing aspect was to keep him to 0.
Long weeks on the sidelines, the return tonight of the game's premier halfback, Andrew Johns. And his timing couldn't have been better. His out-of-form Newcastle side hosting premiers Brisbane.
If the reception was any indication, Brisbane faced a daunting task as they travelled to Marathon Stadium. Newcastle fans welcoming back their favourite son, Andrew Johns, after being sidelined with a knee injury. The test halfback didn't take long to break the shackles, setting up Robbie O'Davis to get the home side off to the start they needed.
Ladder brushes away. Newcastle in support. O'Davis. Rob O'Davis. He's in to score.
It was clear to see the Knights meant business. The skipper capping off a fairy tale return.
Inside for Johns. Johns is over. Andrew Johns is over. Or maybe he isn't Marathon, the great man.
With 10 players backing up from Origin duties, even an Alan Langer curtain call wouldn't have rejuvenated the visitors. And when 5'8 Sean Rutter made it a 22-point ball game at half time, the Broncos were in trouble.
They've isolated Saylor, and away it goes to Hughes, back on the inside. Rutter, Rutter's over. This is fantastic.
Andrew Johns continued to write the script after the break, his world-class return continuing into the second half.
Then away from Peden. Peden away for Johns. Joey's over again.
All Wayne Bennett could do was witness the rampage. The Knights white hot as centre Mark Hughes put the match beyond doubt.
Johns looking for Rudder, finding Hughes.
The Johns led Knights hammering the visitors, Brisbane suffering their worst loss in Premiership history.
And that is an extraordinary scoreline. Andrew Johns almost certainly playing his way straight into the Australian team for next week's test against New Zealand. He set up 6 tries for his teammates, scored 2 of his own, and kicked 6 goals for good measure.
Unbelievable. Unbelievably good from him and from the team, I thought.
I was really confident. I thought we'd beat them. But, they were really ripe, I think, coming off a big win like that. And I would have done a little bit of celebrating, I suppose. The pleasing aspect was to keep them to zero with all the firepower they got out there. And
I was in the coaching slump for a month now.
No, I'm not angry. I'm not even cranky, to be honest with you. These players are more, they've done a tremendous job. I've got a lot of kids there, and they got to learn how to back up after State of Origin. I can't teach them that. That's just an experience thing. So I'm realistic, and I know what happened out there tonight, and I can live with that.
After 10 weeks on the sidelines, it took Andrew Johns just 80 minutes to all but guarantee the Australian number 7 jumper for next Friday's test against New Zealand. Johns dominated last night's match against Brisbane. He set up 6 tries, scored 2 of his own, and kicked 6 goals. The Broncos copping a 44-point hiding.
The morning after the night before, and the Broncos still coming to terms with their biggest defeat.
It was embarrassing. It was really embarrassing last night, and it's probably the worst defeat I've had at this club. But in saying that, we got to regroup and get together.
Their nemesis, Andrew Johns, after 10 weeks on the sidelines, producing an unforgettable return to action.
Inside for Johns. Johns is over. Andrew Johns is over. Or maybe he isn't Marathon, the great man.
The performance almost certain to secure him the Australian halfback spot ahead of Kamali and Barrett. The team to play New Zealand is announced tomorrow night.
Then away from Peden. Peden away for Johns. Joey's over again.
I don't know. Whatever happens, happens. But I wouldn't mind a shot at it.
Wendell Saylor more forthright about his chances.
Look, I just kept rubbing my eyes last night to see what he was doing out there. The bloke's had 8 to 10 weeks off, and you just got to respect the bloke like that and appreciate the way he plays.
They treat him as a god, and last night Newcastle fans were praising the comeback of Andrew Johns.
Fair rap.
It was Johns' first game in 10 weeks, but with just his second touch of the ball, the Knights were in for their opening try. Adam McDougall was also heavily involved as Newcastle piled on the points. But it was Johns who constantly brought a packed stadium to its feet.
Or maybe he is a Marathon, the great man.
Another highlight was the duel between McDougall and Wendell Saylor. The arch rivals went at each other all night.
Walk away!
In an incredible 80 minutes, there was no way through for the defending premiers. And by full time, Brisbane had suffered its biggest defeat in the club's history. John's performance also settled any arguments over who will be Australia's halfback in next week's test against the Kiwis.
Peden away for Johns. Joey's over again.
44-0 to Newcastle. And what a letdown for the Broncos after last week's Origin highs. Clinton Fletcher, National 9 News.
Last night, Newcastle thumped the Broncos 44-0.
After 10 weeks on the sidelines, Andrew Johns made an impact with his second touch of the ball at Marathon, putting Sean Rutter through a hole. Robbie O'Davis did the rest. The Knights were untouchable early on, and their halfback was heavily involved, running off Gidley for Newcastle's second.
Johns is over!
McDougall topped that effort 3 minutes later, triggering another four-pointer, Brisbane down 22-0 and wondering what hit them.
Runners over! This is fantastic!
The Knights didn't let up. McDougall went hunting his opposite number, and Shane Webke had similar ideas.
Oh, what a swinging arm over the top from Webke.
But Brisbane couldn't stop the man that mattered.
Peated away for Johns. Joey's over again.
He scored a double and had a hand in four others as Newcastle brought Wayne Bennett down from his Origin high. A hat-trick from Darren Albert completing the nightmare, Brisbane handed its worst ever defeat. Joey a firm favourite to become the Australian number seven.
It's worth mentioning Johns' magnificent form in the test.
Andrew Johns has come back from a 10-week knee injury and he's successfully won Man of the Match awards two successive weeks. There he is for Australia there, flicking the ball out to Barrett. Those two are going to be the face of Australian Rugby League in the future. It's half and 5/8, leaders of the nation over the next two or three years as Australia continues its great dominance in the great and glorious game of rugby league.
Who do you think will actually be the next captain for the Australian side? Do you think it would be Barrett or Johns?
There's been a few names. I think they'll go for Barrett for the future. He's also got a very, very homely, decent, warm, wholesome image, which is very consistent with the great standards that the game has been setting in recent times.
Absolutely. Even over Gordon Tallis? Over Gordon Tallis?
Gordon, I don't think Gordon Tallis will ever play rugby league again. There's a scoop for your channel, sir.
I want Hopper. That'll make some headlines. And good well done.
By the way, Hopper is going to go down in the annals of history.
Oh, boom, start for the Storm at Newcastle when they opened the scoring through Marcus Bai, but their luck didn't last for long as the Knights showed their class. When Julian Bailey put Ben Kennedy away, they led 18-6 at the break. He and new test hooker Danny Bedaris grabbed doubles on what proved to be an easy day.
Nothing pleases a coach more than when a set play falls into place. And Newcastle really clicked against the Storm.
What a play by Newcastle.
Howe wondered why when Perry hit him. It finished on report. The incident took little shine off the night show, with tries to almost everyone in the red and blue.
Well, less than 2 days after inspiring Australia to victory over New Zealand, Andrew Johns has done it again for Newcastle. Hooker Danny Bedaris also starring for the Knights against Melbourne.
Leading out his beloved Newcastle, Johns' premium skills were on show from the outset. But it was a horror start for Ben Kennedy, his hands letting him down several times.
Kennedy has put another one down.
A touch of luck mixed with skill gave Melbourne the early jump.
Over the top to Marcus Bai, luck's a fortune.
But that was as good as it got for the Storm. Newcastle winger Adam McDougall in scintillating form.
Loops a pass over the top to Mark Hughes. They've replied.
Kennedy bounced back from his nightmare start with a hand in this.
McDougall, what a play by Newcastle.
And then scored one of his own.
Kennedy is there. He'll score for the Knights as well.
Concern for Mark Hughes, unable to play on with a back injury, and trouble for Josh Perry after this high shot on Rodney Howe. After the break, more magic from Johns, first a 40-20 kick, then perfect placement for Darren Albert, who was unable to hang on. A relentless Newcastle piled on five second-half tries.
It comes back for Paul Margaret. He will give it back to Medeiros. What a week for the young hooker.
Before Johns was given a well-deserved rest, and Danny Medeiros capped off a memorable weekend.
Bailey, back to Medeiros. Oh, scored, Danny, scored.
He did score. In fact, he scored twice today. So too did Kennedy and McDougall. Andrew Johns kicking 6 out of 6 in a 48-16 win.
Adam McDougall, who was struggling a little bit yesterday, probably had his best game again today for us. Joey was terrific. And Matty Gidley, I thought, was outstanding before he came off towards the end of the game. So, and I thought the team supported those guys exceptionally well, and I think they appreciate having that quality of player in the football team with them.
Yeah, the excuse I can give is just we just lacked a lot of intensity today from, I would say, you know, I started off pretty slow, but I think our whole game was slow. And, you know, go out with that sort of enthusiasm, we're going to get our bum smacked, no matter who we're playing.
Of course, Michael Hagan inside the Newcastle dressing room. I'm sure he's a very happy coach, and here he is with Brett Kenny.
Well, Mike, I guess you're happy with the result, but early in the first half, a little bit scratchy.
Yeah, I think we're all suffering a little bit from
being a bit flat perhaps, and probably playing in the heat and a few things, we just didn't look to be as sharp as we sometimes normally are. But I thought once we got ourselves into the game, we scored a couple. I think it was at different times we turned the heat up on them a little bit and got ourselves pretty comfortably in front.
Yeah, there was a lot of mistakes early in the game from both sides, but your guys seemed to capitalise in the second half on the mistakes made by the Storm.
Yeah, I thought the second half, probably the first 20 minutes of that period, we certainly converted the opportunities we had into points, and we've got some very good players that are capable of scoring points, and we're good enough to go on with it from there.
You seemed to attack the right-hand side defence of the Storm. Was that something that was organised earlier?
I think there's, normally there's an opportunity to attack certain people, and that certainly was the case in some respects. But, the players, to their credit, were good enough to take that opportunity when it came along, and we're good enough to get a couple on them down that side.
Well, congratulations on today's win, and best of luck next week.
Thanks, Bert.
Thanks, Mike. It's
a young man at the back who's about to get into enormous trouble from his parents this evening. Very embarrassed parents, I would say.
He's a young Newcastle boy too.
So Pip in the crowd having a good time as well.
Looks a bit young. He's getting in practice for years to come. I think
he's got something.
Newcastle membership drive is happening tonight up there at NBN and Newcastle, and three of the Newcastle Knights join us right now. Well, Mark Hughes does. Welcome, Mark.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Take it away, champ. How's it going there?
Yeah, it's going pretty good. We've got all the boys here. We're hoping tonight to sign up a lot of members for the Knights Club. So we're going pretty well on the paddock, but we need a lot more sponsorship off the paddock. So we're hoping the people of New South Wales and around Australia will get behind us.
Everyone who rings up tonight actually gets to speak to a Newcastle first grader. There's the number there. It's 1300 732 273. When you ring, someone will answer. He'll be a Newcastle first grader. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. It's the who's who of the Knights down here. They're all here. Johns is here. They're all here. The phones are already ringing. So it's going to be really good.
Mate, congratulations on the football as well. Your household going along very nicely. You played state footy. Danny Medeiros, who's next to you, test football. Going great.
On you, Danny. Well done, champ.
Well done,
mate. How'd you find last Friday night, Danny?
Mate, absolute dream. Had a ball and... mate, it's just something I always remember, and just the players you mix with, it's just something you'll take to your grave.
Well, who have you got behind there? If the first grade's there, who have we got in shot? I can see
the Knight
Rider.
Hey, you Knight Rider.
There he is. We've got the Knight Rider. How's the phone going, mate? Are you getting many calls?
Yeah, she's running red hot. The supporters are out tonight.
There it is from the Knight Rider. That's quality. We've got Matt Gidley here. Gids, how are they going?
Yeah, good booze. Mate, there's plenty of... the phone's going mad.
Yeah, they're all very busy. We've got over here in the kitchen. We've got Darren Alberts over here and Billy Peden. Boys, how's it doing?
Yeah, not too bad, mate. We're having trying to get a bit of cuppa in between the phone calls. It's at the moment we're a bit hectic.
Mate, what about cooking? You got anything cooking in there? Billy, what's happening?
Yeah. Hang on, mate, I'll just take my kettle off.
Yeah, they're all pretty busy.
What about Andrew Johns? He's down there, no one's talking to him. Is not popular at all?
Mate, not many people like him, actually. He's pretty popular down here. We'll have a bit of a word with him. How are they going, Andrew?
Yeah, good, Boozy. Hughesy.
Oh, that's good, mate. That was good. Thanks for that. Real good. Okay, we'll move over to the lounge. We've got some casual sort of customers over here. And obviously they're pretty busy too, so it's all really good. It's a good start. They're all flat out. And we've got the number, obviously... 1300 732 273.
Now that number as well, you can see underneath 9msn.com.au/footyshow. You can also get into our website because we have a Newcastle link. So if you come into our website, get to the Newcastle link, and you can actually get membership for the Knights through that avenue as well.
All right, Mark, thanks for joining us, mate. We're going to come back to you a bit later in the show.
Yeah, boys, just quickly hang on, right? Yeah. Oh, we'll see you later.
Mate, what were you going to say?
Mate, the Knight Riders offered to do 10 push-ups and 10 star jumps for every member that we get signed up tonight.
All right, then.
So the Knight Riders going to be going that. Off.
Right, all right, thanks boys. Catch you later. The boys up there in Newcastle. Big membership drive. And by the way, we're going to try to do this for every club over the remaining rest of the year on the Footy Show. We want to help all the clubs get plenty of members, make it easier for them. It's time to trek back to Newcastle to see how it's all going out there, boys. How's it doing, Mark?
Yeah, it's going real good up here, guys. The phones have been running really hot. We've had calls from all around Australia, ACT, we've got Tweed Heads, Ellie Barner, Foster, Ningen. The big surprise of the night is we've got a couple from Newcastle, so we're going pretty well. I've also roped in our little mate here, Andrew Johns, who's obviously had a good couple of weeks, so I'll fire a few questions at him.
Yeah. Good question, Yuzi.
Okay, well, the phone number is 1300-73-2273.
What am I doing up here?
So, we'll have a look around. We've got the Knight Rider here doing push-ups. So he's doing a good job for us. What about that phone over there? Someone get the phone over there for us. Oh, look out, we've got Robbo. Robbo's turned up. You know, so it's a...
Yeah, Kirsty, grab Joey for us for a sec. We will have a...
Yeah, how about have a word for him, guys? He won't listen to me. Here he is.
Yeah, Joey, can you hear us all right?
Yeah, mate, I can hear you.
Mate, last week, last Friday night, must have been tremendous satisfaction to finally get the green and gold number 7.
Yeah, mate, it is. It's been a long while in coming, but it's good to finally get a crack, and hopefully my form can keep up to the end of the year and go on the Kangaroo Tour and keep that position. But, yeah, Brett's going to keep me on my toes, but it was good to get a start.
How do you feel about Matty coming back?
Yeah, not too bad, actually. Should be good. Catch up in a bit and give me an excuse to get to Sydney, I suppose, on weekends. But yeah, it's good. I miss him being away, so it's going to be pretty interesting playing against him, bud.
Should be good. Hughesy, just one for you, mate. How's your little body going? You haven't missed a game in 74 games consecutively. You're missing your first match in a long time. How are you going?
Yeah, Chief, I've broke a couple of ribs, so I'm going to have a couple of weeks off. So I've just got a new spa put in, so I've been utilising that.
You've been giving a bit of a hind.
Yeah, thanks to Blue Pools and to Sterlo for that. Hey, look after you.
Wish I could get one.
Well,
let's go well, boys.
All right, good on you, Mark. We'll cross back to you again in a couple of segments. All right, keep it going. Mark Hughes, boys up there having a good time. Now, look, we crossed there a couple of times tonight. We're heading back to wrap it up there at the NBN Newcastle membership drive. Hughesy, you're on again, champ.
Thanks for coming. Thanks, guys. Yeah, it's been very good here tonight. We've had a great response, and we're going to be here for a bit longer. We've got Robbo and the Easy Rider here going hard at it. If you can't get through, we encourage you to ring newcastleknights.com.au on the website, and you'll get through that way. And I've been told to tell you the price, which is pretty important. It's $35 to join up, or if you're under 16, it's $11. So thanks very much for the response, and we hope everyone keeps going.
Mark, how many members do you reckon you've got so far tonight?
How many members? Oh, anywhere between 1 and 2 million, I think. we're not sure, but the phones are running hot and the boys are doing a good job, so I'm sure it's going to be
a success.
And the
boys said they'll stay there till about 3 o'clock, won't they, in the morning?
Yeah, that's about right. About 3 or 4.
Then back to the spa.
Good stuff.
All right, thanks very much, Mark. Hughes,
okay,
and the boys
guys.
Done a great job for us up there. Keep ringing in on that number. And as I said, we're opening that up to all sorts of clubs in the next 11, 12 weeks that the comp is running.
Now, Paul, I've got a very good post-try celebration in Falcon for you coming up. The post-try celebration, I think this one has gone to the lead. It comes out of the Newcastle game on the weekend. It's actually missed by most cameras. Features Darren Albert and Robbie O'Davis after Darren Albert scores this try. Now, we get a very good view of it later on, but it's a resuscitation job on the ball. Robbie O and Darren Albert... This shows it up very nicely.
That's elaborate. That's big time.
Good on you, boys.
And from the same game, here's a Falcon. In fact, it probably should have been a try, but have a look at slow motion. Ben Kennedy gets the melon in the road. The little kick from Tasessa Lavia, bang. So that'll go into our draw as well for the end of the season. Awards night, which is coming around very quickly. I thought that should have been a try. He went all the way
should
and scored
been, yeah.
there.
Matty Johns has been on the news. He's just signed a new 2-year deal with Cronulla, and he's joining us now from his home in the north of England. G'day, Matty.
Yeah, g'day, boys. How are you going over there?
No, we're good, thanks, Matt. Now, listen, an enormous week for you. You're a Shark.
Yeah, Fatty, that's right. There's been a bit of speculation over the last couple of weeks. It's true there's an illness in the family back home, so my wife and myself decided that we're better off being close to the family back there. And one thing's led to another, and now I'm playing for Cronulla next season. Looking forward to it, mate.
In joining the Sharks, obviously Chris Anderson helped that decision. Were the Knights ever an option?
Newcastle really wasn't an option because it's a very sort of, they're on a tight budget there with a salary cap, and they've proven that in the past. You know, and You know, and as well as that, on top of that, they got, you know, the 5'8 spot is pretty much, it doesn't need any more filling. Sean Rutter, you know, he's filled it fairly well this year, and you know, he's proven that, you know, he can fill, you know, that spot in the future without a doubt. And of course there's Matty Gidley as well, and as well as his younger brother coming through, Kirk Gidley. So really, you know, to go back to Newcastle, I was probably just overloading the number six position, whereas the Sharks are looking for somebody, and it's a new challenge as well. You know, it's a brand new challenge, and you know, that's something we're looking forward to.
The big question, Matty, the first time you play your brother Andrew, how are you going to handle that?
Yeah, Chief, it's going to be different, mate. That's for sure. Coming up against Joey, I mean, I've got a fair idea how good a player he is. You know, played alongside him all those years and seen him develop. And I mean, basically, apart from being my brother, it's going to be a handful because, really, at the moment, he's the number one player in the world and daylight second. You know, so I'm under no illusions of how tough it's going to be. So it's going to, not only Andrew, you know, just to run out of Marathon Stadium in front of all those Newcastle fans against all my old teammates, it's going to be different. But, I mean, football's not a personal game. I played against a lot of my best mates, you know, and even though they may run over the top of you a few times, you don't hold grudges. Yeah, it's probably going to be something to look forward to, you know. I've had a great time in Newcastle. The fans are always good to me, and I don't think they'll begrudge me going back for a new challenge with the Sharks.
Matty, I've spent some time in the UK. What's been the highlight for you?
Yeah, well, Wendell, probably the last 6 to 8 weeks has been fantastic over here. You know, the weather's improved out of sight. It's summer over here at the moment, and, you know, the weather, you know, when you're playing those evening games, so we play Friday nights at 8 o'clock, and you know, it's a fantastic time of the day to play, because it doesn't get dark at this time of the year till 11 o'clock at night, so... Yeah, it's really good. And you know what's helping us too is we're one of our seven on the trot. So as a footballer, you enjoy it more when you are winning, and we're going through a good patch. And I've really enjoyed my time here. It's been a good change. The teammates are a good bunch of blokes, as most footballers are. And you know, there's going to be a part of me that's sorry to leave, but that's the way it goes, mate.
Yeah, Matty, speaking of English players, is there one standout that you'd like to bring home with you?
Yeah, well, Braith, it's hard to pick one standout. There's a few English players that I think could make the jump tomorrow and handle it without a doubt. One of those is my teammate Chris Radlinski, the fullback, who's been in great form, and he's a really mentally tough type competitor. As well as he's very safe, and he knows how to bob up in positions. He's picked up a couple of hat tricks this year for us, and he's been in great form.
Well, Matty, in summing up, is the English game now richer for your presence?
Yeah, well, Fatty, I think, you know, from my presence here, you know, I think I've probably pushed the game forward about 150 years, actually. But, I'll send it back to the Stone Ages.
Good to speak to you, Matty. Thanks for joining us. Look forward to you coming home. Thanks, mate.
Righto, boys. Thanks very much. I'll see you next year on Good Night. See you later, Chief. Have a good day later, mate.
Yeah, Matty John's there. Don't you just love television? I'm loving life, aren't you? Loving life, Pete?
It's fantastic. Love life, boy.
We're loving this footy show. We'll take a break and come back with plenty more very soon.